Takže ešte raz, nech vás Boh všetkých veľmi mocne požehná. Je to už skoro rok, keď pastor Richard tu bol medzi nami minulý rok prvýkrát a teraz prišiel a pred chvíľou hovoril, že do konca roka, pokiaľ to bude možné, niekoľkokrát ešte pricestuje a bude tu slúžiť v našom regióne. Takže veľmi sme sa tešili. Ja len trochu poviem, ktorý možno nepoznáte Richarda. On je zo služby Rodneyho Howarda Browna, slúži ako jeden z pastorov tam v Tampe, v Tampa River Church a je takisto medzinárodným evanjelistom, káže Božie slovo, takže s láskou ťa, Richard, vítame. Amen.
Halleluja.
Halleluja.
Halleluja, church.
Halleluja, cirkev.
Come on, say it like you mean it. Halleluja.
Povedzte to, ako keď to myslíte.
Praise the Lord. I mean, if we're going to be Christians and serve the God that's alive,
my sme kresťania a slúžime Bohu, ktorý je Bohom lásky.
We got to act like it, we got to talk like it. Amen.
Musíme tak jednať a musíme tak rozprávať.
Hallelujah. Well, it's such an honor to be back here tonight.
Je to tak úžasné, že môžem byť zase medzi vami.
And I get to hang out for the next couple days with your pastor Adrian for it's going to be awesome.
A budem tu tieto dva večery s vašim pastorom Adriánom, je to úžasné.
When I met him last year, I was immediate connection in the Holy Ghost.
A keď som ho minulý rok stretol, okamžite som mal také spojenie v duchu s ním.
And I appreciate and love your pastor.
A ja si vážim a cením vášho pastora.
And I also I like the fact that he likes Harleys.
A tiež sa mi páči, že má rád Harley.
But I want to tell you I have been looking forward to my return.
A chcem vám povedať, že tešil som sa veľmi na to, že sa vrátim.
You know, I've been here for 2 weeks now.
A už som tu 2 týždne.
And last year when I came for 2 weeks, we ended up here the last night.
Minulý rok, keď som sem prišiel, tak sme tu skončili a to bol posledný večer.
And we had a blowout in the Holy Ghost.
A mali sme tu výbuch vo Svätom Duchu.
And so this year we're ending up here again.
Takže to sa tu môže opäť uskutočniť.
And all I can tell you is you don't want to miss tonight and tomorrow.
A verím, že nechceš minúť ani dnešok, ani zajtrajšok.
I can tell you that I have been in 56 countries of the world.
A môžem ti povedať, bol som v 56 krajinách sveta.
That over 120 times.
Viac ako 120 krát.
And I can tell you out of all the countries I've been to.
A môžem ti povedať, že zo všetkých krajín, kde som bol.
Apart from America where I live.
Mimo Ameriky, kde žijem.
I think Slovakia is the next best country.
Myslím si, že Slovensko je tou ďalšou najlepšou krajinou.
Really, I mean that.
A ja to tak myslím vážne.
So I fell in love with Slovakia and Czech Republic.
Takže ja som si zamiloval aj Slovensko, aj Českú republiku.
But Slovakia has a slight edge over Czech Republic.
Ale Slovensko prečne má trošku o taký kúsok.
But I love your country, your nation.
A mám rád veľmi vašu krajinu a národ.
I love it so much that I'm gonna come back every 2 months.
A milujem to tak veľmi, že sa to sem budem vrácať každý druhý mesiac.
You know, and for the next few years until Jesus comes back.
Najbližšie 3 roky, až dokiaľ sa Ježiš nevráti.
Amen. I'm going to help your pastor and other pastors shake Slovakia.
A pomôžem vášmu pastorovi a ostatným pastorom, aby ste zatriasli Slovenskom.
Because I believe that this nation shall be shaken.
Pretože verím, že tento národ musí byť zatrasený.
And I believe that the church of the Lord Jesus Christ in Slovakia is rising up.
A verím, že cirkev Ježiša Krista na Slovensku povstáva. A my v týchto posledných dňoch budeme tou cirkvou, ktorou Boh po nás chce, aby sme boli.
Church of the Lord Jesus Christ is not weak, it's not anemic, it's not poor and it's not sick.
Cirkev Ježiša Krista nie je slabá, malá, malátna, je to ani chorá, ani chudobná.
But we are the church of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Ale my sme cirkev Pána Ježiša Krista.
He is the head of the church.
On je hlavou cirkvi.
And he's given us all authority and all power.
A on nám dal všetku autoritu a všetku moc.
the church of the Lord Jesus Christ is not here to just barely get by.
Cirkev Ježiša Krista nie je tu len aby len tak prežila.
The church of the Lord Jesus Christ in Slovakia is not here to sit in a corner and eat from the crumbs that fall off the wealthy's table.
Cirkev Ježiša Krista na Slovensku nie je tu, aby sedela niekde v rohu a živila sa omrvinkami, ktoré padajú od bohatých.
We are the army of God in the land.
My sme tou armádou Božou v tejto zemi.
And we've been clothed with all of his glory and all of his power and all of his might.
A my sme boli odetí do celej jeho slávy, do celej jeho moci a do celej jeho sily.
There's no force, there's no army that can withstand the church of the living God.
Neexistuje žiadna sila vo vesmíre, ktorá by vedela odolať cirkvi Ježiša Krista.
And nothing can stop us because God is our source.
A nič to nevie zastaviť, pretože Boh je našim zdrojom.
So I'm looking forward to the next to come back every couple months.
Takže ja sa veľmi teším na to, že sa sem budem z času na čas vracať.
And then every month we have a powerful evangelist sitting on the front row.
A máme tu jedného mocného evangelistu, ktorý sedí vpredu.
You know Alex?
Poznáte Alexa?
He comes back every month.
A on sa sem vracia každý mesiac.
So Alex and myself, we're going to help the pastors here and we're going to shake Slovakia, amen, and
takže,
Czech Republic.
Takže my s Alexom sem budeme chodiť a budeme pomáhať, aby sme zatriasli Slovenskom, amen.
It's so funny, as soon as I seen your pastor again.
Je to vtipné, odtedy, čo som znovu stretol vášho pastora.
First thing he said to me that I've changed.
Prvú vec, ktorú mi povedal, je, že som sa zmenil.
I found the fountain of youth.
Našiel som fontánu mladosti.
And I might tell you about it. I don't know. Come back tomorrow night and I'll tell you.
A vráťte sa zajtra, ja vám o tom poviem.
obviously I'm not anymore.
Ale vidíte, zjavne už nie som napúčaný veľmi.
I have shrunk.
Trošku som sa stvrkol.
Actually, last time when I was here last year.
Naposledy minulý rok, keď som tu bol.
I was so big.
Som bol tak veľký.
That my suit coat right now.
Že ten môj oblek.
It's used as a tent in Africa to house a family.
Je teraz sa používa ako stan v Afrike, aby tam mohla žiť jedna rodina.
Hallelujah, but I think I've actually put on a few pounds since I've been here.
Myslím, že som kým som tu, tak už som nejaké kilko nahodil.
Because one thing I noticed about Slovakia.
Pretože jednu vec som si Slovensku všimol.
Every single night.
Každý jeden večer.
Before the service.
Pred zhromaždením.
And after the service.
A po zhromaždení.
There's so many sweets and cakes and
je tak veľa koláčikov a rôznych sladkostí.
You know, I mean, I walk in the room and it's like in the name of Jesus, you know.
Vošiel som do tej miestnosti a dal som takto, že v mene Ježiš.
And it's sitting right in front of me.
A ono to sedí tam rovno predo mnou.
I mean, we all like sweets.
My všetci máme radi sladké.
And I'm trying to talk to the pastor.
A ja sa snažím rozprávať s pastorom.
But my eyes keep going like that, looking at the sweets.
Ale moje oči išli stále tam, že ako by som si jednu uchmatol.
But Hallelujah. But it's a great honor to be here.
Ale je to obrovská podsta, že tu môžem byť.
You know, last time we came, we were in 10 churches in 10 nights.
Naposledy, keď som prišiel, bol som za 10 nocí v 10 zboroch.
But this year we've been in most of the churches 3 nights.
Ale teraz vo väčšine zborov, čo som bol 3 večery.
And we're here 2 nights here.
A tu sme 2 večery.
But next time we'll come back, we'll go like a whole week.
Ale na budúce, keď sa vrátime, budeme aj celý týždeň.
Because what happens with us in America?
Pretože to, čo sa deje u nás v Amerike.
I'll go to a church.
Ja idem do cirkvi.
We'll be there, we're supposed to be there for a week and we'll end up being there 5 weeks every night.
A mali by sme tam byť jeden týždeň a skončíme tým, že sme tam 5 týždňov a každý jeden večer.
Because the glory of God comes.
Pretože Božia sláva zostúpi.
And the hunger level arises and the faith arises.
A tá úroveň hladu rastie a aj viera rastie.
You're going to see that tonight after the service you're going to be more hungry tonight than you were when you came here.
Dnes po tejto službe budeš vidieť, že budeš o mnoho hladnejší ako keď si sem prišiel.
Your faith is going to be stronger tonight when you leave here more than it was when you came here.
tvoja viera porastie a bude silnejšia, ako keď si sem prišiel.
So every night we just increase.
Takže každý večer proste rastieme.
See, the Bible says we go from glory to glory.
Biblia hovorí, že ideme od slávy k sláve.
As the church we never go backwards.
Ako cirkev my nikdy nejdeme späť.
We always go forwards.
My ideme vždy vpred.
As the church we never decrease.
Ako cirkev nikdy sa neumenšujeme.
We always keep increasing and increasing and increasing.
My stále sa zväčšujeme a rastieme.
But the increase I'm talking about, I'm not just talking about when it comes to the presence of God or the anointing.
Ale o raste nehovorím len ako o pomazaní a Božej prítomnosti.
Now, I am talking about that.
Áno, hovorím aj o tom.
But I'm also talking about revelation.
Ale hovorím tiež aj o úrovni zjavenia.
And I'm also talking about our hunger for God.
A hovorím o našom hlade po Bohu.
And I'm also talking about finances.
A hovorím takisto aj o financiách.
The church of the Lord Jesus Christ, we never decrease. I don't care that there is a plague in the land. We never decrease.
Ako cirkev Ježiša Krista, my sa nikdy nezmenšujeme. Či je aj nejaká pliaga v meste alebo nie, my sa nikdy nezmenšujeme.
Now, if the world was our source, then we would decrease.
Ak by svet bol našim zdrojom, tak by sme pravdepodobne klesali.
But the world is not the head. The government of the world is not the head of the church.
Ale vláda tohto sveta nie je hlavou cirkvi.
Jesus is the head of the church.
Ježiš je hlavou cirkvi.
The creator of all things.
Stvoriteľ všetkých vecí.
The creator of heaven and earth.
Stvoriteľ neba a zeme.
He is the head of the church.
On je hlavou cirkvi.
He is our head. He is our authority.
On je našou hlavou, našou autoritou.
He's the one we answer to.
On je ten, komu sa zodpovedáme.
And he has no shortage.
A on nemá žiaden nedostatok.
Heaven does not have a shortage going on.
Nebo nemá žiaden nedostatok.
He's our source.
On je našim zdrojom.
Therefore it doesn't matter how many plagues are in the world.
Preto nezávisí na tom, koľko takýchto priag je vo svete.
We will continue to increase.
A my budeme pokračovať a budeme rásť.
Because God is our source.
Pretože Boh je našim zdrojom.
We're not gonna miss a step.
My neminieme ani jeden krok.
We're not gonna lose a beat.
A nestratíme ani jeden úder.
Because the very one that created the heavens and the earth by faith with his words.
Pretože samotný Boh, ktorý stvoril nebesia a zem svojimi slovami.
He's our God.
On je náš Boh.
He's the one that's on the inside of us.
On je ten, ktorý je v nás.
And he's given us his name, amen.
A on nám dal svoje meno.
Let's think about it. He's the one that caused water to come out of a rock.
On spôsobil, aby zo skaly vytekala voda.
Do you understand?
Rozumieš?
Tonight you serve.
Komu dnes slúžiš?
Do you understand tonight who you worship?
Rozumieš dneska, že koho uctievaš?
Do you understand tonight the one you pray to?
Rozumieš dnes, že ku komu sa modlíš?
The Bible says that there is nothing impossible unto him.
Biblia hovorí, že jemu nič nie je nemožné.
And if there's nothing that's impossible unto him,
a ak nie je nič jemu nemožné,
then that means that you and I that are his heirs, that are his children,
tak aj my, ktorí sme jeho dedičmi a jeho deťmi,
that means we walk in the impossible.
To znamená, že aj my kráčame v tom nemožnom.
That means we walk in the supernatural.
To znamená, že kráčame v nadprirodzenom.
Because we are in him.
Pretože my sme v ňom.
And he is in us.
A on je v nás.
And he has no shortage.
A on nemá nedostatok.
We don't decrease, we always increase.
My sa nezmenšujeme, my vždy rastieme.
The Bible says in the book of Psalms that he increases us more and more and more.
Biblia v Žalmoch hovorí, že on nás zdvíha viac a viac a viac.
Amen.
Amen.
So don't even think decrease. Don't even think shortage.
Takže vôbec nerozmýšľaj o umenšení alebo o nedostatku.
Don't even talk lack.
Ani nehovor o tom, keď niečo nemáš.
Understand, not one person here tonight.
Žiadna osoba tu.
That has called on the name of the Lord Jesus.
Ktorá volala na meno Ježíš.
That's washed in his blood.
Ktorá je obmytá v jeho krvi.
That has your name written in the Lamb's book of life.
A ktorej meno je zapísané v knihe Baránka.
We don't talk defeat.
My nerozprávame porážku.
We don't talk lack.
Nehovoríme nedostatok.
We don't talk sickness and disease.
Nehovoríme chorobu a nemoc.
We don't talk fear.
A my nehovoríme strach.
Why? Because we don't live as the world lives.
Pretože my nežijeme, ako žije svet.
Because we are new creation.
Pretože my sme nové stvorenie.
That's seated with Christ in heavenly places.
Ktoré je posadené s Kristom v ponebeských oblastiach.
And the Bible says that he's seated at the right hand of the Father.
Biblia hovorí, že on sedí po pravici Božej.
The Bible says that all powers and principalities and powers of darkness are under his feet.
Biblia hovorí, že všetky moci temná sú pod jeho nohami.
And because we're seated with Christ in heavenly places,
a pretože my sme posadení s Kristom v nebeskej oblasti,
that means all darkness, all principalities, all powers are under our feet.
Tak to znamená, že všetka temnota, všetky mocnosti a všetky sily sú pod našimi nohami.
Amen.
Amen.
Even storms obey us, the church.
Dokonca aj búrky poslúchajú cirkev.
Understand every force, everything that's of the kingdom of darkness must loose that when we say loose.
Rozmýšľaj, že keď my povieme buď rozviazaný, tak každá táto vec zlá musí odísť.
Must stop when we say stop.
Musí prestať, keď povieme stoj.
Because we're the church.
A pretože my sme cirkev.
Amen.
Amen.
I want you to turn with me to the in your Bibles tonight to the book of Matthew.
Otvorme si do Matúša.
Chapter 16.
Kapitola 16.
Matthew chapter 16.
Matúš kapitola 16.
I'm sorry, Matthew chapter 18.
Prepáč, kapitola 18.
Hallelujah. Father, tonight I ask you to move in this house.
Otče, žiadam ťa, aby si dnes sa hýbal v tomto dome.
Lord, I thank you that not one person will leave here as they've come.
Ďakujem ti za to, že žiadna osoba, ktorá sem prišla, neodíde rovnaká.
Let the fire of heaven fall.
Nech oheň z neba spadne.
I curse all sickness and disease and witchcraft.
Preklínam každú chorobu, každú nemoc a každé čarovanie.
I bind the force of darkness.
Zavezujem každú silu temnoty.
Of every individual here tonight.
Každého jedného individua tu na tomto mieste.
Holy Spirit, move in this house, walk up and down each aisle and each row.
Svätý Duchu, hýb sa v tejto miestnosti a každou jednou uličkou.
Let the fire of heaven fall in this house tonight in Jesus name.
Nech oheň z neba spadne na tomto mieste dnes večer v Ježišovom mene.
Sickness and disease must loose you.
Každá choroba, my ťa preklíname v mene Ježiš.
Poverty must go from you.
Každá nemoc musí odísť od teba.
Lack must go from you.
Nedostatok musí odísť od teba.
In the name of Jesus.
V mene Ježiš.
Father, I thank you that revelation.
A Otče, ďakujem ti, že zjavenie
is released in this house tonight.
Je uvoľnené teraz v tomto dome.
And that every individual here tonight sees you as who you are.
A že každý jeden človek, ktorý je na tomto mieste, ťa uzrie, aký si, a nech Božia viera porastie.
In Jesus name.
V Ježišovom mene.
If you believe that, shout amen.
Ak tomu veríš, povedz amen.
Matthew chapter what chapter did I tell you to go to?
Do ktorej kapitolu som vám povedal, že máte ísť?
18. Well, I was wrong. It's 16.
A pomýlil som sa, je to 16.
It's page 1277.
Je to strana 277. 1270.
In my Bible anyway.
Moje Biblie.
Starting with verse 13.
Začneme vo verši 13.
When Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples saying, "Whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?"
Keď Ježiš prišiel do končín Cezarej Filipovej, opýtal sa svojich učeníkov, za koho pokladajú ľudia Syna človeka?
And the disciples answered and they began to tell him who the people are saying that he is. And they said this.
A odpovedali jedni za kráľa, krstiteľa, druhý za Eliáša, iní za Remiáša, alebo jedného z prorokov.
Some of the people are saying you're John the Baptist or Elijah.
Takže pýtali sa a odpovedali.
Some of the people saying that you're Jeremiah and some are even saying that you're one of the prophets.
Jedni, že si Ján Krstiteľ, druhý Eliáš, iní ťa pokladajú za Jeremiáša alebo za jedného z prorokov.
So they tell Jesus who the people are thinking or who think he is.
Takže on sa pýtal ľudí, aby mu povedali ich názor, že čo si myslia, kto je.
But I want you to know what Jesus says to the disciples now.
Ale chcem, že by ste si všimli, čo Ježiš povie teraz učeníkom.
Jesus makes his next question to the disciples personal.
Ježiš robí túto otázku pre svojich učeníkov veľmi osobnú.
And in verse 15 Jesus said to the disciples, "But who do you say I am?"
A vo verši 15 Ježiš sa ich opýtal, a vy ma za koho pokladáte?
Who do you say I am?
Čo hovoríte, že kto som ja?
Jesus asked the disciples, "Who do you say that I am?"
Ježiš sa pýta učeníkov, čo hovoríte, kto som ja?
It's important tonight who you believe he is.
Je veľmi dôležité dnes večer, čo veríš, kto je on.
Because by what you believe is how you're going to live and is how you're going to receive.
Pretože to, ako budeš veriť, je ako znamená, ako budeš žiť a ako budeš prijímať.
And it's amazing to me how religion has gotten into the church and lied to the church about God.
Je zvláštne pre mňa, ako náboženstvo sa dostalo do cirkvi a klamalo o Bohu.
But the only way to find out who he is,
ale jediný spôsob zistiť, kto on je,
is to get into the scriptures,
je vstúpiť do týchto písiem
and to get into his presence.
A dostať sa do jeho prítomnosti.
And many in the world, many in the religious world, they see God as someone that's angry.
A mnohí v náboženskom svete vidia Boha ako niekoho, kto je nahnevaný. Sú ľudia, ktorí neprišli dnes do cirkvi, pretože boli naučení, že Boh ich dostane za ich chyby.
And they see God as such a God of judgment.
A vidia Boha ako Boha súdu.
Now there is the judgment side of God, don't get me wrong.
A samozrejme, že existuje súdna stolica.
But one thing you have to understand about your father.
Ale jednu vec, ktorú musíme porozumieť o našom otcovi.
He is a good God, the Bible says.
Je, že on je dobrý Boh, Biblia hovorí.
And he's a God of love.
A on je Boh lásky.
And it was because of love.
A práve kvôli láske.
I mean, no, love is an action.
Koľko viete, že láska je skutok?
Love isn't just words.
Láska nie sú len slová.
I mean, if all you ever do is tell your wife, I love you, I love you, I love you, and I love you, I love you.
Vieš, mohol by si hovoriť svojej žene, milujem ťa, milujem ťa, milujem ťa.
And you don't ever show her you love her.
A nikdy jej nepreukážeš lásku.
Then she's gonna question your love.
Tak začne spochybňovať tvoju lásku.
Love is an action.
Láska je skutok.
It's one thing to say I love you, it's another thing to show your spouse you love them.
Jedna vec je povedať niekomu, že ťa milujem, a druhá vec je ukázať svojmu partnerovi, teda svojej manželke, že ju miluješ.
And God is love.
A Boh je láska.
And he displayed his love by his action.
A on ukázal svoju lásku svojim skutkom.
And his action was sending his very own son into this world.
A ten skutok bol, že poslal svojho jednorodeného syna, jediného syna.
That's contaminated with sin, sickness, disease, death and poverty.
Ktorý aby porazil hriech, chudobu, smrť.
He sent his son into this world.
Poslal svojho syna na tento svet.
To redeem mankind.
Aby vyslobodil ľudstvo.
Because mankind was of their father the devil.
Pretože ľudstvo pochádzalo od svojho otca diabla.
The nature of mankind was that of the devil.
Tá natura, tá prirodzenosť človeka bola z diabla.
Because of Adam and Eve's mistake, their sin.
Kvôli Adamovi a Eve, ktorí urobili chybu.
But the Bible
riechom.
Also calls Jesus the second Adam.
Ale Biblia takisto nazýva Ježiša druhým Adamom.
And he came here and he was perfect.
A on prišiel sem a bol dokonalý.
He was sinless.
Bol bez hriechu.
God sent his son.
Boh poslal svojho syna.
God himself came to this earth.
V tele prišiel na túto zem.
The very one that the Bible says in the book of Hebrews, the third chapter.
Ten, o ktorom už v 3. kapitole na začiatku Biblie sa hovorí.
The very one that created the world out of nothing.
Ten, ktorý stvoril tento svet z ničoho.
He came and took upon flesh and blood.
Ten, ktorý zobral na seba telo a krv.
And for 33 and a half years he walked on this earth.
A 33,5 roka kráčal po tejto zemi.
Think about it, the very world, the very earth he created, he walked on.
Takže ten, tú samotnú zem, ktorú stvoril, on po nej kráčal.
At night he would lay his head on the ground or be in the boat and look up at the sky and see the stars.
Keď bol večer, tak ležal na zemi alebo na lodi a pozeral sa na hviezdy.
Think about it for a moment.
Rozmýšľa nad tým chvíľku.
The very God that in the book of Psalms.
Ten samotný Boh, o ktorom v knihe Žalmov.
The very God that with his breath created the stars.
Je napísané, že svojím dýchom stvoril hviezdy.
Is now on the earth that he created.
A teraz je na tejto zemi, ktorú sám stvoril.
And as he looks up to the sky, he sees the stars that he created with his breath.
A on sa díva na to nebo, kde sú tieto hviezdy, ktoré stvoril svojím dýchom.
See, love is an act.
Vidíš, láska je skutok.
Love is a display.
Láska sa ukazuje.
And the Bible says that God so loved the world that he displayed it by sending his own son.
A Biblia hovorí, že Boh tak miloval svet, že to ukázal tým, že poslal svojho syna.
And the Bible says that God didn't send his son into the world to condemn it.
A Biblia hovorí, že Boh neposlal svojho syna na svet, aby ho odsúdil.
But that the world might be saved through him.
Ale aby svet bol zachránený, spasený cez neho.
Think about it for a moment.
Rozmýšľaj nad tým chvíľku.
When I read the gospels.
Keď čítam evanjelia.
As we read Matthew chapter 16 here.
Keď sme teraz čítali Matúša 16.
I mean, I try to picture myself there.
Ja sa tam vždycky snažím sám seba predstaviť, že som.
When Jesus is talking to the disciples here in Caesarea Philippi.
Keď tu v Cezarei Filipskej hovorí Ježiš k učeníkom.
I try to picture myself there.
Snažím sa tam predstaviť, ako keby som tam
bol. I read about blind Bartimaeus.
Keď čítam o Bartimeovi.
When Jesus is walking through Jericho and blind Bartimaeus begins to cry out, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me.
Keď Ježiš šiel cez Jericho a Bartimeus slepý kričal, Ježiš, zmiluj sa nado mnou.
I mean, I try to picture myself there.
Ja si to snažím tak predstaviť, ako keby som tam bol.
And think about it for a moment.
Chvíľku nad tým rozmýšľaj.
Here is God in the flesh on the earth that he created.
Tu je Boh v tele na tejto zemi, ktorú sám stvoril.
I mean, there's 10,000 people that's following him.
Je 10,000 ľudí, ktorého nasleduje.
And the Bible says they were hungry.
A Biblia hovorí, že boli hladní.
And then he needs to feed them.
A on ich potrebuje nakrmiť.
And so they bring unto him two fish and five loaves of bread.
Tak mu donesú dve rybičky a 5 kúskov chleba.
And yet he's going to bless the fish that he actually created.
A on ide žehnať tú rybu, ktorú stvoril.
I mean, he looks up and sees the stars at night.
Takže pozrie sa večer a vidí tie hviezdy.
And he sees the stars that he created with his breath.
A vidí tie hviezdy, ktoré stvoril svojím dýchom.
I mean, think about it for a moment.
Rozmýšľaj nad tým.
Now there's 10,000 people that are hungry and he's got to feed them.
A je tu 10,000 ľudí a on ich má nakrmiť.
And so he asked what's present to feed them with.
A tak sa pýta, že čím ich nakrmiť.
And he said, well, the little boy's got a couple of fish and some loaves of bread.
A oni povedali, že je tu jeden chlapec, ktorý má dve ryby a niekoľko chlebov.
Jesus says, bring it to me.
A Ježiš hovorí, doneste mi to sem.
See, understand something tonight.
Rozmýšľaj dnes niečo.
It's a little side note.
Jedna taká poznámka.
Understand the importance of your giving.
Rozumej dôležitosti svojho dávania.
God will bless what is in your hands.
Boh požehná to, čo je v tvojich rukách.
You might just have a little.
Môžeš mať len málo.
But God will make the little much if you put it in his hands.
Ale Boh z toho mála urobí veľa, ak ho dáš do jeho rúk.
And we see that with the five loaves of bread and two fish.
A on tam je s týmito piatimi chlebmi a dvomi rybičkami.
Now, here's what religion will do.
A toto by spravilo náboženstvo.
Religion, that's why stay away from religion.
Preto sa drž ďaleko od náboženstva.
Stay away from religious people.
Buď ďaleko od náboženských ľudí.
Don't hang around people of doubt and unbelief.
Nezdržiavaj sa okolo ľudí, ktorí majú nevieru a pochybnosti.
Don't hang around people who think real little.
Nezdržiavaj sa okolo ľudí, ktorí si myslia, že ja som taký maličký.
That's what I love about your pastor. He thinks big.
Ja, mne sa páči, ako rozmýšľa váš pastor. Rozmýšľa vo veľkom.
Understand something tonight.
Rozmýšľaj dnes nad niečím.
Don't think little when you serve a big God.
Nerozmýšľaj v malom, keď slúžiš veľkému Bohu.
Don't think in terms of limitation when you serve a God that has no limitation.
Nerozmýšľaj v limitoch, ak slúžiš Bohu, kto nemá žiadne limity.
Amen.
Amen.
That's why I don't ever talk lack. Don't ever talk sickness, disease. Don't ever talk defeat.
Takže nikdy nevyslovuj porážku, chudobu alebo chorobu.
Now religion will try to explain away the power of God.
Náboženstvo sa bude snažiť ti vysvetliť túto moc Božiu.
I mean, even the feeding of the at least 10,000 people.
Dokonca aj nakrmenie minimálne 10,000 ľudí.
Religion will explain it away and say stupid stuff like
Náboženstvo sa to bude snažiť nejakým spôsobom vysvetliť a povie hlúpe veci ako.
You ever think about how stupid religious people are?
Už si niekedy rozmýšľal nad tým, aký hlúpi sú títo náboženskí ľudia?
I mean, religion will say, well, back in them days, they had big loaves of bread and big fish.
Náboženstvo povie, že v tých dňoch mali veľké ryby a veľké chleby.
In America, we would call those people a special kind of stupid.
V Amerike by sme nazvali tých ľudí, že oni sú špeciálne hlúpi.
Think about it.
Tak rozmýšľaj nad tým.
I mean, they forget that it was a little boy's lunch.
Oni zabudli na to, že to bol vlastne obed toho malého chlapca.
I mean, religion would make you think that this little boy is carrying two Moby Dicks around.
Náboženstvo ti vysvetlí, že ten chlapec niesol dvoch Moby Dickov.
But they were little fish.
Veľa ryby. Ale to boli dve malé rybky.
And little loaves of bread.
A malé kúsky chleba.
It was not enough to feed 10,000. It was enough to feed the little boy.
Nebolo to dosť na to, aby to nakrmilo 10,000. Bolo to dosť, aby to nakrmilo aspoň toho chlapca.
See, religion tries to explain away the supernatural.
Vidíš, to náboženstvo sa snaží zle vysvetliť to nadprirodzené.
Religion tries to do away with miracles.
Snaží sa zle vysvetliť zázraky.
I'll tell you this story that happened to me one time.
Poviem vám jeden príbeh, čo sa mi stal.
I was talking to this real religious guy.
Rozprával som sa s týmto jedným náboženským človekom.
Do you ever notice that religious people are, first off, they're very boring?
Všimli ste si, že náboženskí ľudia sú poprvé veľmi nudní?
I mean, I've met some rocks that have more personality than some religious people.
Stretol som nejaké kamene, ktoré majú viacej osobnosti ako títo náboženskí ľudia.
And they're always sad.
A oni sú vždy smutní.
And there was light.
A bolo svetlo.
See, miracles are already happening.
Vidíš, už sa dejú zázraky.
They're always sad.
Oni sú vždy smutní.
They're always depressed.
Sú vždy deprimovaní.
I mean, have you ever noticed religious people?
Všimli ste si týchto náboženských ľudí?
Now, nobody here is religious.
Tu nikto nie je náboženský.
I mean, because your pastor is already run off the religious people.
Pretože váš pastor už vyhnal náboženských ľudí.
Thank you, pastor, for making my job easy.
Ďakujem, že si mi to uľahčil, pastor.
No, listen, we're not religious. We're the family of God.
My nie sme náboženskí, my sme rodina Božia.
Amen.
Amen.
We're family.
My sme rodina.
God's our father.
Boh je náš otec.
The Bible says that our spirits cry daddy God. That call our spirits call him daddy.
Áno, že Biblia hovorí, že náš duch spolu so Svätým Duchom volá otecko.
But religious people, they're always so sad.
Ale náboženskí ľudia sú vždy takí smutní.
I mean, just take notice next time you see a religious person.
No, proste si všimni, keď na budúce budeš vidieť nejakého náboženského človeka.
They look like they've been sucking on lemons all day.
Vypadajú ako keby celý deň žuli citróny.
And they're cheap.
A sú také lacné.
They never give.
Oni nikdy nedávajú.
And so I had this religious person one time.
A ja som sa jednej také náboženskej osoby opýtal raz.
He tried to tell me that when Moses parted the Red Sea, that really wasn't a miracle.
A snažil sa mi povedať, že keď Mojžiš rozdelil more červené a prešiel tá ďalej, že to nebol zázrak.
I said, what are you talking about?
A ja sa pýtam, o čom hovoríš?
He said, because
pretože
they've proved that the sea that supposedly Moses parted, that some places are knee deep.
Dokázali, že to miesto, kde Mojžiš rozdelil tú vodu, so that je len potiaľto hlboké po kolená.
So that just shows that the sea was not parted, they walked across.
Takže to len dokazuje, že to more nebolo rozdelené, oni len cez to prešli.
I'm sitting there looking at him like,
a ja sa sedím a pozerám na ňoho.
So you know what I did?
Viete, čo som povedal?
I shocked him.
Ja som ho šokoval.
I went, whoo!
Urobil, že
you gotta do what I do, you're my interpreter. No, you gotta do it properly.
Proper.
Not. I didn't go, woo! I went, woo!
Dobre, ja som neurobil woo, ale woo!
And then I looked at him after I did that and he's going.
Potom som sa na neho pozrel a už bol mimo.
He was shocked.
Bol šokovaný.
Because he thought he had me.
Alebo si myslel, že on ma dostal.
He thought he proved to me that really wasn't a miracle.
Myslel si, že mi dokázal, že v skutočnosti to nebol zázrak.
You know what I said to him?
Viete, čo som mu povedal?
I said, you know what you're telling me?
Vieš, čo mi hovoríš?
I said, that's even greater of a miracle.
Tak to je ešte väčší zázrak.
And he goes, how is it greater of a miracle?
A on sa pýta, že ako by to mohol byť ešte väčší zázrak?
I said, because that means that God drowned a whole Egyptian army in knee-deep water.
To by znamenalo, že Boh potopil celú egyptskú armádu vo vode, ktorá je len po kolená.
See, religion tries to explain away the supernatural.
Vidíš, náboženstvo sa snaží odviesť pozornosť od nadprirodzeného.
That's why don't hang around religious people.
Preto sa nemotaj okolo náboženských ľudí.
Don't hang around people of doubt and unbelief.
Nemotaj sa okolo ľudí, ktorí majú pochybnosti a nevieru.
All of my friends?
Všetci naši moji priatelia.
I love your pastor.
A ja mám rád tvojho vášho pastora.
I don't have any friends of mine that live in doubt and unbelief.
Ja nemám žiadnych priateľov, ktorí žijú v pochybnostiach a neviere.
I don't want them in my life.
Ja ich nechcem vo svojom živote.
Because guess what?
Pretože hádaj čo?
We can choose who's in our life.
My si môžeme zvoliť, kto bude v našom živote.
Amen.
Amen.
Because life is a choice.
Pretože život je voľbou.
Because you chose to come here tonight.
Ty si si zvolil, že sem prídeš dnes.
An angel didn't pick you up and carry you here.
Aniel ťa nezobral a nepreniesol sem.
You were not translated.
Nebol si prenesený
vzduchom. No, you chose to come here.
Ty si si zvolil, že sem prídeš.
Life's a choice.
Takže život je voľba.
Matter of fact, God said that he set before us life and death.
V skutočnosti Boh povedal, že predkladám ti život a smrť.
And then he gives us a little hint.
A potom nám dáva takú jednu nápovedu.
He says, but choose life.
Ale že vyvol si život.
See, it's our choice.
Takže je to naša voľba.
You choose who's in your life.
Ty si zvolíš, kto je v tvojom živote.
Amen.
Amen.
I tell you right now, if you start hanging around with people who sometimes go to church and sometimes don't go to church.
Poďte, keď sa budeš stretávať s takými ľuďmi, ktorí raz idú do cirkvi, raz niekedy neidú do cirkvi.
You'll become like them.
Budeš taký istý ako on.
You hang around people that criticizes the pastor, you'll start criticizing the pastor.
Ak budeš okolo ľudí, ktorí kritizujú pastora, aj ty začneš kritizovať pastora.
You hang around people who are poverty minded, who are stingy, you'll become that way.
Ak budeš okolo ľudí, ktorí sú rozmýšľajú o chudobe a sú skúpi, budeš taký istý.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says that we've been redeemed from poverty, sickness, disease and death.
Biblia hovorí, že sme boli vyslobodení z chudoby, choroby a smrti.
If we've been redeemed from poverty, sickness, disease and death,
a ak sme boli vykúpení z chudoby, choroby a smrti,
then our mind should not even think poverty, sickness, disease and death.
Tak naša mysel by nemala ani rozmýšľať nad týmito vecami.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't hang around people who think in terms of lack, because then you'll never do nothing.
Nechoď okolo ľudí alebo nebuď s ľuďmi, ktorí rozmýšľajú o nedostatku, pretože aj ty skončíš môžeš skončiť nedostatku.
You hang around people that's on fire for God and you'll stay on fire for God.
Keď sa budeš držiavať okolo ľudí, ktorí majú oheň Boží, tak aj ty budeš mať oheň Boží.
You hang around people that are passionate about God and you'll be passionate about God.
Keď budeš okolo ľudí, ktorí majú takú pasiu, vášeň po Bohu, budeš aj ty mať.
You hang around people that tell people about Jesus and you'll tell people about Jesus.
Ak ty budeš okolo ľudí, ktorí hovoria o Ježišovi, tak aj ty budeš hovoriť o Ježišovi.
Amen.
Amen.
You hang around people that believe in miracles and you'll believe in miracles.
Ak budeš okolo ľudí, ktorí veria v zázraky, budeš aj ty veriť v zázraky.
You hang around people that think big and are radical in their giving and you'll think big and be radical in your giving.
Ak budeš ty chodiť s ľuďmi, ktorí rozmýšľajú o veľkom a veľa dávajú, budeš aj ty taký istý a budeš dávať.
Think about it tonight.
Tak rozmýšľaj dnes o tom.
We are not servants.
My nie sme sluhovia.
Now, we are to serve.
Máme slúžiť.
And we are God's servant.
A sme Boží služobníci.
But when we come to the throne room of God,
ale keď prichádzame do tej trónnej miestnosti Božej,
we do not come as servants.
Neprichádzame ako sluhovia.
We come as children.
Prichádzame ako deti.
Because he's our father.
Pretože on je náš otec.
And he told us to come boldly.
A on nám povedal, aby sme prišli s odvahou.
So that we might obtain mercy.
Aby sme získali milosť.
Listen, when God tells us to come boldly into his throne, come boldly.
Keď ti Boh povie, aby si prišiel s odvahou k jeho trónu, tak príď s odvahou.
God said to call unto him and he'd answer us.
A Boh povedal, že volaj na mňa a odpoviem vám.
Not only will he answer us, he said he'll show us great and mighty things that we know not.
A nie len, že nám odpovie, ale ukáže nám ešte aj veľké veci, o ktorých nevieme.
Oh, I sense the presence of the Lord here tonight.
Cítim tu teraz Božiu prítomnosť.
I already see faith arising in people.
Už cítim, ako ľuďom rastie viera.
I can already see on some faces that God's becoming a whole lot bigger than you thought he was when you came in here tonight.
Už vidím na niekoho tvárach, že si presvedčený o tom, že Boh je o mnoho väčší, ako keď si sem prišiel.
He's God.
Lebo on je Boh.
No, he is God.
On je Boh.
But he's not just God unto us.
A on nie je nám len Boh.
He's Father.
On je Otec.
Because we're his children.
Pretože my sme jeho deti.
We have his life, we have his nature.
Máme jeho život, máme jeho prirodzenosť.
We have his ability.
Máme jeho schopnosti.
And here in Caesarea Philippi,
a tu v Cezarei Filipskej,
after he asked the disciples who people said he was,
potom, čo sa spýtal učeníkov, čo si ľudia myslia o ňom, že je,
makes it personal.
Začína sa pýtať osobnú otázku.
He says, but who do you say I am?
Ale vy, kto, čo hovoríte, kto som ja?
See, it's important that you know who he is.
Je veľmi dôležité, aby si vedel, kto on je.
See, it's important that you know that he is El Shaddai, the God that is more than enough.
Aby si vedel, že on je Boh toho viac než dosť, El Shaddai.
It's important that you know that he is Jehovah Jireh, your provider.
Aby si vedel, že on je Jahve Jireh, Boh, ktorý zaopatruje.
It's important that you know that he's Jehovah Rapha, your healer.
Aby si vedel, že on je Jahve Rapha, Boh, ktorý ťa uzdravuje.
It's important that you know that he's the God of miracles.
A je veľmi dôležité, aby si vedel, že on je Boh zázrakov.
It's important that you know who he is.
Je veľmi dôležité, aby si vedel, kto on je.
Because that when you know who he is, then you can approach him for who he is.
Pretože ak vieš, kto on je, môžeš tak k nemu pristúpiť.
Remember what he said in Hebrews chapter 11, what God said to us?
Viete, čo Boh hovorí k nám v Židom 11?
He said without faith it is impossible to please him.
Je tam napísané, že bez viery je nemožné sa mu ľúbiť. Ale potom ide ďalej a hovorí v tom istom verši.
Are you ready?
Si pripravený?
Those that come to him must believe that he is.
Že tí, ktorí k nemu pristupujú, musia veriť, že on je.
So if you need a miracle in your body, you must come to him knowing that he's the God of miracles.
Takže ak potrebuješ zázrak vo svojom tele, musíš vedieť, že on je Boh zázrakov.
Believing that he's the God of miracles.
Musíš veriť, že on je Boh zázrakov.
Because those that come to him must believe that he is.
Pretože ten, ktorý k nemu prichádza, musí veriť, že on je.
And are you ready for this?
A si pripravený na to ďalšie?
He finishes the verse by saying this.
A on dokončuje ten verš týmto.
That he is a God, that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him.
A že on odpláca tým, ktorí ho snažne hľadajú.
Think about it. Think about it.
Rozmýšľaj nad tým.
God said.
Boh povedal.
If you diligently come after me.
Ak usilovne pôjdeš za mnou.
I will reward you.
Ja ti odplatím.
Do you know God is a rewarder?
Vedel si, že Boh je tvojim odplatiteľom?
But most people in the church.
Väčšina ľudí v cirkvi,
especially those in the world,
hlavne tí, ktorí sú vo svete,
especially religious people,
hlavne náboženskí ľudia,
they don't see God as he is.
Oni nevidia Boha takého, aký on naozaj je.
They don't see him as a rewarder.
Oni ho nevidia ako ten, ktorý odpláca.
But God said to us in Hebrews 11 verse 6 that he's a rewarder to those who diligently seek him.
Ale Boh hovorí cez Židom k nám, že on je ten, ktorý odpláca tým, ktorí ho usilovne hľadajú.
Do you realize tonight that God wants to reward you?
Uvedomuješ si dnes, že on je Boh, ktorý ti chce dať odmenu?
Think about it.
Rozmýšľaj nad tým.
How many of you grew up in a religious home or religious church, right?
Koľký z vás ste vyrástli buď v náboženskom dome alebo v náboženskej cirkvi?
Some people.
Niektorí ľudia.
Were you ever told that God wants to reward you?
Už vám niekedy niekto povedal, že Boh je váš, že vám chce dať odplatiť dobré veci?
You were raised in a religious church?
Bol si vychovaný v náboženskej cirkvi?
Were you
Catholic?
Were you ever told that God, what's your name?
Ako sa voláš?
Rubel?
Ľubo.
Okay, I'm gonna change your name to Paul.
Dobre, zmením tvoje meno na Pavol.
Okay, Paul.
Dobre, Pavol.
Meet Paul tonight.
Zoznámte sa s Paulom.
Paul, you was raised in a religious.
Paul, ty si bol vychovaný v náboženskej cirkvi.
Were you ever told that God wants to reward you?
Už ti niekedy povedali, že Boh ťa chce odvďačiť, odmeniť?
Kým som sa neobrátil, tak nikdy.
Never. Because religion doesn't see God that way.
Pretože náboženstvo takto nevidí človeka.
But God said this right here in Hebrews chapter 11.
Ale Boh to hovorí tu v Židom 11.
Verse 6. Matter of fact, let me just read it to you so you'll know that I'm not just saying it.
Dobre, ja vám to prečítam, aby ste vedeli, že ja to len nerozprávam.
Can you put it on the screen?
Môžete to dať aj hore, Židom 11:6.
Let's put it on the screen.
Dajte to.
Hebrews chapter 11. I want to show you this.
Židom 11.
Because it's time to come up higher.
Je čas, aby sme trošku išli vyššie.
It's time for those in this church to come up higher.
Je čas, aby táto cirkev vyrástla.
Because you're not called here to just get by.
Pretože nie si sem povolaný len aby si tu bol.
We're the church.
Ale my sme cirkev.
We're called to rule and to reign.
My sme povolaní vládnuť a vládnuť.
We are here to advance God's kingdom in the earth.
My sme tu na to, aby sme Božie kráľovstvo rozšírili v tomto svete.
And look at what he said here.
Pozri sa, čo tu hovorí.
Listen to the end of this verse.
Pozri sa na koniec tohto verša.
And God, he says here,
a tu je napísané, že a Boh
he is a rewarder
je odplatiteľom
of them that diligently seek him.
Tým, ktorí ho snažne hľadajú.
God is a rewarder.
Boh je ten, ktorý odpláca.
No, God is a rewarder.
Boh je odplatiteľom.
No, you're not getting it. God is a rewarder.
Ty si to ešte nezískal. Boh je odplatiteľom.
You're going to get it tonight in the name of Jesus.
Neboj sa, my to získame dnes večer.
God is a rewarder.
Boh je odplatiteľ.
He's a rewarder.
On je odplatiteľ.
For those who seek him.
Pre tých, ktorí ho hľadajú.
He's a rewarder to those who obey him.
On je odplatiteľom pre tých, ktorí ho poslúchajú.
He's a rewarder to those who call unto him.
On odpláca tým, ktorí na ňo volajú.
Oh, Oh, marasa karabashatai. Oh, I tell you.
Poviem ti.
You're not going to thank little bitty anymore in this church. Hallelujah.
Už nebudeš takej maličkosti rozmýšľať v tejto cirkvi.
Oh, you're going to thank in terms of abundance.
Budeš rozmýšľať v termínoch množstva.
Because he is El Shaddai.
Pretože on je El Shaddai.
He's the God that is more than enough.
On je Boh, ktorý je Boh, Bohom viac.
No, no.
Ako dosť.
He is not just enough.
On nie je len Boh dosť.
He's not the God that is just enough.
On nie je len Boh, aby si mal len dosť.
He's the God that is more than enough.
Ale on je Boh, ktorý je viac ako to dosť.
And think about it.
Rozmýšľaj nad tým.
God himself.
Boh sám.
The one that holds the worlds in the palm of his hand.
Ten, ktorý drží celý svet v dlani svojich rúk.
The one that causes the sun to stand still.
Ten, kto povedal, aby slnko stálo.
He said,
on povedal,
he would reward you,
že on ti odplatí,
if you diligently seek him.
Ak ho usilovne hľadáš.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He said, if you obey him,
on povedal, že ak ho budeš poslúchať,
you'll spend your... Listen, the Bible says,
počúvaj, Biblia hovorí.
I feel like this is the way the Holy Ghost is leading tonight.
Cítim, že takto nás Svätý Duch vedie dnes večer.
Because tonight I'm looking not only am I looking at a bunch of healed people.
Pretože dneska sa dívam na skupinu uzdravených ľudí.
I'm looking at a bunch of blessed people.
Ale dívam sa aj na skupinu požehnaných ľudí.
I'm looking at a bunch of wealthy people.
Na skupinu bohatých ľudí.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Well, I thought you'd get more excited than that.
Myslel som, že sa trošičku viacej potešíte ako takto.
Let me say it again. Maybe,
poviem
maybe
to
you
ešte raz.
Interpret it right.
Možno to prekladateľ nedal dobre.
I'm looking at a bunch of blessed and wealthy people tonight.
Dívam sa na skupinu požehnaných a bohatých ľudí dnes večer.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Do you know the Bible says in the book of Job?
Viete, čo hovorí Biblia v knihe Joba?
I believe it's Job 36, 11 or 12.
Myslím si, že to je Job 36, 11 alebo 12.
Do you know what the Holy Ghost said to Job?
Viete, čo Svätý Duch povedal Jobovi?
Are you ready for this?
Si pripravený na to?
God said that if you serve me,
Boh povedal, že ak mi budeš slúžiť
and obey me,
a budeš ma poslúchať,
you'll spend your days in prosperity and your years in pleasure.
Stráviš svoje dni v prosperite a svoje dni v pôžitku.
That didn't come from the book of Richard.
To nepochádza z knihy Richarda.
That's not an American gospel.
Toto není americké evanjelium.
That's the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
To je evanjelium nášho Pána Ježiša Krista.
Just pull up Job 36, I believe it's 11 or 12.
Len si otvor
well, there it is.
Job
right up there.
36.
So what does that say? Look to me it looks like tongues.
Pre mňa to vyzerá ako keby to bolo v jazykoch. Čo sa tam píše?
What's it say?
Yeah, that's it.
Is that the verse?
It is. Ak posluchnú a budú mu slúžiť, strávia svoje dni v dobrom a svoje roky v rozkoši.
God said,
Boh povedal,
if you serve him,
ak mu budeš slúžiť
and obey him,
a poslúchať ho.
How many of you serve God in this house? Raise your hand.
Koľký z vás slúžite Bohu na tomto mieste?
Okay. Zodvihnite. How many of you obey God? Raise your hand.
Koľký z vás poslúchate Boha? Zodvihnite svoju ruku.
Do you know according to the scripture?
Vedel si, že podľa tohto slova?
That if you serve him,
že ak mu slúžiš,
and you obey him,
a budeš ho poslúchať.
The Bible says, it's time we believe the Bible.
Je čas, aby sme verili Biblii.
That you'll spend your days in prosperity and your years in pleasure.
Že svoje dni stráviš v prosperite a svoje roky v radosti.
So why think so little?
Takže prečo tak málo rozmýšľať?
Why think in terms of limitation?
Prečo rozmýšľať v tých limitoch?
Change the way in the name of Jesus you think.
Zmeň ten spôsob, ako rozmýšľaš v Ježišovom mene.
Think in terms of the word of God.
Začni rozmýšľať v termínoch Božieho slova.
Think in line of the word of God.
Rozmýšľaj v línii Božieho slova.
Listen, we don't serve a God that has to, you know, sell the pearly gates.
Vieš, my neslúžime Bohu, ktorý musí predať...
Our God
náš Boh
has not had to sell the gates of heaven.
Aha, že nemusel predať tie brány neba.
Because he's in a shortage.
Pretože on by mal nedostatok.
He doesn't have to sell the streets of gold.
Nemusí tie ulice zo zlata predávať.
He's El Shaddai.
On je El Shaddai.
There's no COVID in heaven.
V nebi nie je žiaden COVID.
Do you know the angels don't get COVID?
Vedeli ste, že anjeli nedostávajú COVID?
I mean, you listen to religious people.
Vieš, ty počúvaš náboženských ľudí.
I mean, you think half the angels in heaven have the heavenly COVID.
A ty si myslíš, že polovica anjelov v nebi majú nebeský COVID?
Oh, but he's El Shaddai.
Oh, ale on je El Shaddai.
He's mighty.
On je mocný.
There's none like him.
Nie je nikto ako
There's
on.
None like him.
Nie je nikto ako
There's
on.
None like him.
Nie je nikto ako on.
There's none like our God.
Nie je nikto ako náš Boh.
And he wants you to come after him.
A on chce, aby si šiel za ním.
He wants you to seek him.
Chce, aby si ho hľadal.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Lord, touch him.
Pane, dotkni sa ho.
Lord, don't kill him, just touch
him. Ho, iba sa ho dotkni.
Oh, hallelujah. Is this your wife?
To je tvoja žena?
Huh? That's your wife?
Je tvoja žena?
Okay, I was just wondering.
Ja sa len čudujem.
I mean, she's all over you. I was just wondering. She was all over you.
Lebo bola celá na tebe. Sa len pýtam.
I was going to say, if she wasn't your wife, welcome to your wife.
Že ja som chcel povedať, že ak není tvoja manželka, tak že asi sa dáte dohromady.
Do you know, I always ask the question.
Vieš, vždy sa pýtam otázku.
Like when I see couples, you know.
Vidím páriky.
I always ask if they're married.
A vždy sa radšej pýtam, že či sú svoji, či sú vzatí.
Because I learned the hard way one time.
Pretože raz som sa to naučil veľmi trpko.
I was in a church one time.
Raz som bol v cirkvi.
And I saw these two people sitting, you know, I called them up to pray for them.
A videl som ich vpredu, ako sedeli, a zavolal som ich dopredu a modlil som sa za nich.
And I said to this man,
a hovoril som tomu mužovi,
I said, sir, is this your son here with you?
A povedal som, synu, je toto tvoj syn tuto?
And he looked at me and he goes, no, it's my wife.
Sa na mňa pozrel a povedal, nie, to je moja manželka.
And I was like,
a ja som bol,
I wanted to crawl under the carpet.
Ja som sa chcel zahrabať pod koberec.
So I always ask now.
Takže ja sa teraz vždy pýtam radšej.
That's why I ask.
Preto sa pýtam.
Now Paul's talking on the front row.
Teraz Pavol hovorí tuto v prednej rade.
There is a names day here in Slovakia.
Oh, names day.
For each name. Yeah.
You get to celebrate.
Takže budeš oslavovať.
Paul gets to celebrate. Hallelujah.
Paul bude už oslavuje.
You know what's so funny? Everybody's going to start calling you Paul now.
Vieš, čo je vtipné, že teraz ťa všetci budú volať Pavol.
Ha, ha, ha. At least I didn't say Olga. At least I said Paul and not Olga.
Ešte, že som povedal Paula, nie Olga.
Now see, if anybody here was religious, they would have already got up and left.
Ješ, keby tu bol niekto náboženský, už by sa postavil a odišiel preč.
Because they don't like joy.
Nemajú radi veľmi radosť.
God is a rewarder.
Boh je odplatiteľom.
To those who diligently seek him.
Pre tých, ktorí ho usilovne snažne hľadajú.
So here's how you well it was gone, but here's how you need to think.
Takto musíš rozmýšľať.
You need to begin to declare some things.
Potrebuješ začať vyznávať určité veci.
Don't settle for lack.
Neuspokoj sa s nedostatkom.
Don't settle for a life that it's not God's will for you to have.
Nezvykni si na taký život, pre ktorý Božia vôľa nie je pre teba.
Jesus did not come here tonight. Listen to me.
Ježiš neprišiel sem dnes večer.
He did not come here to give us a better version of our old life.
Aby nám dal lepšiu verziu nášho starého života.
He came to give us a brand new life.
On prišiel, aby nám dal úplne nový život.
That's why the Bible says that if any man be in Christ,
preto Biblia hovorí, že ak je niekto v Kristovi,
he's a brand new creation.
Tak je úplne novým stvorením.
Old things have passed away.
Staré veci pominuli.
Behold, all things have become new.
A hľa, nastali nové.
Think about this.
Rozmýšľaj nad tým.
Do you realize tonight?
Uvedomuješ si, že dnes večer?
I told this a couple nights ago.
Povedal som to aj pred niektorými večermi.
Do you realize tonight?
Uvedomuješ si dnes večer,
those of you that have made Jesus the Lord of your life,
že tí, čo ste učinili Pána Ježiša svojim pánom,
matter of fact, how many of you here you've made Jesus the Lord of your life? Raise your hand.
Koľký z vás ste učinili Ježiša svojim pánom na tomto mieste? Nech to vidím.
Okay, I think it's every hand.
Dobre, ja si myslím, že to je každá ruka.
Do you realize that I am not looking at dead people tonight?
Uvedomuješ si, že ja sa nedívam teraz na mŕtvych ľudí?
Do you realize that I'm looking at people? Listen to me.
Počúvaj ma veľmi pozorne.
Help you get a perspective of who you are.
Snažím sa ti zlepšiť ten pohľad toho, kto si.
Not one person here tonight.
Ani jedna osoba tu na tomto mieste.
Will ever die.
Už nezomrie.
Think about it.
Rozmýšľaj nad tým.
You will never die.
Nikdy nezomrieš.
Because the life of God's in you.
Pretože je v tebe Boží život.
Now our body,
no, naše telo,
the flesh,
to telo z mesa,
the house that we live in,
ten dom, v ktorom prebývame,
it gets older,
to stárne,
and eventually goes back to the dust of the earth,
a nakoniec skončí v prachu zeme,
but the real you,
ale skutočný ty,
will never die.
Už nikdy nezomrie.
The Bible says that we leave this world and step right into glory.
Biblia hovorí, že my opustíme tento svet a vkročíme priamo do Božej slávy.
Because our citizenship is in heaven.
Pretože naše občianstvo je v nebesiach.
You, in the natural, you might be a citizen of Slovakia.
V prirodzenom svete môžeš byť občanom Slovenskej republiky. Tak ako ja som občanom Ameriky. Ale vieš, čo je realita?
No one here is a citizen of Slovakia.
Nikto tu z nás nie sme občanmi Slovenska.
I'm not a citizen of America.
Ja nie som občan Ameriky.
My citizenship, your citizenship is in heaven.
Moje občianstvo a tvoje občianstvo je v nebesiach.
Amen.
Amen.
See, we don't live like this world lives.
Takže my nežijeme tak, ako tento svet žije.
God's our source.
Boh je našim zdrojom.
In the world, they're their source.
A vo svete to je ich zdroj.
But God is our source.
Ale náš zdroj je Boh.
The Bible says that we are a brand new creation.
A Biblia hovorí, že my sme novým stvorením.
Old things have passed away, behold, all things have become new.
Staré veci pominuli a hľa, nastali nové.
I shared how when I gave my life to Jesus.
A hovoril som vám, že keď som dal svoj život Ježišovi.
I didn't grow up in church.
Ja som nevyrastal v cirkvi.
I'm thankful that I didn't grow up in a religious church.
Ja som vďačný, že som nevyrastol ani v náboženskej cirkvi.
But I didn't grow up in any church.
Ale ja som nevyrastol v žiadnej cirkvi.
My church was the racetrack.
Moja cirkev bola závodné autá.
Because my family drove race cars.
Pretože moja rodina viedla tieto závodné autá.
And it was my dream as a child, young man growing up to drive race cars.
A môj sen, ako keď som bol malý chlapec, že vyrastiem a budem šoférom takéhoto auta.
I'm gonna be honest with you tonight.
A budem s vami úprimný.
I don't like to go slow.
Nerád idem pomaly.
I think going slow is of the devil.
Myslím si, že ísť pomaly je od diabla.
But then you got religious people.
A potom máš náboženských ľudí.
I had somebody tell me one time.
A raz mi niekto povedal.
I know in America we go by miles per hour. You go by kilometers.
V Amerike my chodíme mile za hodinu a vy chodíte kilometr za hodinu.
So okay, let's say.
Tak povieme, že.
So I'll transfer it to kilometers.
Tak ja to teraz prevediem na kilometre.
So I had somebody in America one time tell me.
Raz mi jeden v Amerike povedal.
If the speed limit is 90 kilometers.
Že ak ten limit je 90 kilometrov.
And you go 91 kilometers.
91 kilometrov.
Then the angels get out of your car.
Tak anieli vyjdu z tvojho auta.
I thought that's so stupid.
A ja som si myslel, to je tak hlúpe.
So you know what I said?
Vieš, čo som mu povedal?
I said, well, you know what I found out?
A vieš, čo ja som zistil?
I said, I found out when I do 200 kilometers.
Ja som zistil, že keď idem 200,
the devil gets out.
Tak diabol odchádza.
People can be so silly.
Ľudia vedia byť takí blázniví.
So I grew up in a racing family.
Takže ja som vyrastol v takejto rodine.
But I remember somebody told me about Jesus every day for 3 months.
Ale pamätám si, ako mi niekto hovoril o Ježišovi každý jeden deň 3 mesiace.
And I remember the day I had a revelation.
A pamätám si na ten deň, keď som mal to zjavenie.
I wasn't saved.
Nebol som zachránený.
I was actually in school sitting beside the guy who told me about Jesus every day for 3 months.
Bol som v škole a sedel som vedľa toho chalana, ktorý mi každý deň 3 mesiace hovoril Ježišovi.
And I remember I looked at him and I said, I don't want to go to hell.
A pamätám sa, ako som sa na ňo díval a hovoril som, ja nechcem ísť do pekla.
He said, well, come to church with me tonight.
A tak on povedal, poď so mnou do cirkvi.
And I said, okay.
Ja som povedal, dobre.
And I remember on the way to church.
A pamätám si na ceste do cirkvi.
I remember I didn't know what to expect. I didn't grow up in church.
Ja som nevedel, čo môžem očakávať, lebo som tam nevyrástol.
And I remember I walked into this church.
A pamätám si, že ako som vošiel do tejto cirkvi.
Remember last time I was here, remember I told you that Colonel Sanders went to my church.
Ak si pamätáte, asi som vám hovoril, že do našej cirkvi chodil ten, who?
You know, Kentucky Fried Chicken?
Áno, Kentucky Fried, ten majiteľ Kentucky Fried Chicken.
He went to my church.
On chodil tam, kde ja, do cirkvi z KFC.
And I remember I walked in.
A si pamätám, že som vošiel dnu.
And everybody's jumping up and down and dancing.
A každý tam skáče a tancuje.
And there was a whole band playing.
A bola tam tá skupina, ktorá hrá.
About 2,000 people.
A bolo tam asi 2,000 ľudí.
And at first it scared me.
A najprv ma to vystrašilo.
I actually thought it was an occult.
Najprv som si myslel, že to je nejaký kult.
I thought, what am I into?
A som si hovoril, že čo budem robiť len.
All I know is I wanted to get saved.
Ale jedno som vedel, že potrebujem byť spasený.
And I remember I'm sitting in the balcony watching, I'm looking at the people.
A ja tam teda sedím vzadu na balkóne a pozerám sa na ľudí.
And I'll be honest with you, I'm nervous and I'm scared.
A som nervózny a som vystrašený.
I've never been to anything like this.
Pretože som nikdy na niečom podobnom nebol.
And my knees were fellowshipping with one another.
A moje nohy mali spoločenstvo jedno s druhou.
And I remember I'm already nervous.
A tak som už nervózny.
And all of a sudden this lady right beside me.
A zrazu tá jedna pani vedľa mňa.
She shouted.
Zakričala.
She goes, "Ha la 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 la."
Urobila la la la.
No my God.
A ja si hovorím, čo to?
The next thing you know, another lady on the other side. La 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 la.
A potom jedna pani na druhej strane, to isté.
The next thing, the whole church. La, 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 la.
A potom celá tá cirkev, la, la, la.
I'm thinking, oh my God.
A si hovorím, oh môj Bože.
I'm thinking, I just want to get saved.
Ja chcem byť zachránený.
I just don't want to go to hell.
Ja nechcem ísť do pekla.
And I remember I said to my friend, I said,
hovorím tomu svojmu priateľovi,
I said, where do all these foreigners come from? What country are they from?
A sa pýtam, že odkiaľ títo cudzinci pochádzajú, z ktorej krajiny?
And he said, man, he said, they're not foreigners.
A on hovorí, to nie sú žiadni cudzinci.
He said, they're speaking in tongues.
Oni hovoria v jazykoch.
I never heard of that before.
A som to ešte nikdy nepočul.
I said, what's speaking in tongues?
Čo je hovorenie v jazykoch?
And he said, oh, don't worry, you're going to get it.
A on hovorí, že neboj sa, aj ty to dostaneš.
I'm like, just wait a minute.
On povedal, počkaj chvíľku.
Just bring me along slowly. Aha. I said, bring me along slowly.
A že preveď ma tým pomaly.
But I remember when they gave the altar call.
Ale pamätám si, že keď urobili výzvu,
I ran down to get saved.
Ja som utekal dopredu, aby som mohol byť
spasený. And I remember when I invited Jesus into my heart.
A ja si pamätám, keď som prijal Ježiša do svojho srdca.
Everything changed.
Všetko sa zmenilo.
I feel it right now.
Aj teraz to cítim.
I became a brand new person.
Stal som sa úplne novou osobnosťou.
See, that's what the Bible says, that when you make Jesus the Lord of your life, you become a brand new creation.
Biblia hovorí, že keď učiníš Ježiša Krista svojim pánom, budeš novým stvorením.
God doesn't come and heal you.
Boh nepríde a uzdraví ťa.
He comes and makes you brand new.
On príde a učiní ťa úplne novým.
And you know what happened?
A viete, čo sa stalo?
At that very moment,
v tom momente,
I became alive.
Som sa stal živým.
See, I was dead.
Vieš, bol som mŕtvý.
But when I made Jesus the Lord of my life, I became alive.
Ale keď som Ježiša učinil svojim pánom, stal som sa živým.
And I remember I walked outside.
A pamätám si, ako som
after the service was over with.
Kráčal von, keď to skončilo. A bol som si tak vedomý všetkého.
I remember I looked at a tree.
Pamätám si, že som sa pozrel na strom.
I started staring at this tree.
A začal som sa dívať na tento strom.
And I'm thinking,
a rozmýšľam. Strom.
Look at the tree.
Strom.
See, I was dead.
Vieš, ja som bol mŕtvý.
I didn't see that things that was alive.
Ja som nevidel tie veci, ktoré žili.
But now I'm alive.
Ale teraz som živý.
I'm like tree.
A hovorím, že strom.
Look at the tree.
Pozri sa na ten strom.
Look how beautiful the tree is.
Aký je nádherný ten strom.
Look how green the leaves are.
Pozri, aké sú zelené tie listy.
Listen.
Počúvaj.
Hear the birds?
Počuješ tie vtáčiky?
I never heard the birds before.
Ja som nikdy predtým nepočul vtáčiky.
Now I'm alive.
A ja som teraz živý.
I hear the birds.
A počujem vtáčiky.
I'm like, listen to the beautiful noise of the birds.
Počúvam na ten krásny štebot tých vtáčikov.
Then I remember I looked at the grass.
A potom sa pozerám na tú trávu.
And I'm like, grass.
Tráva.
Look at the grass.
Odkiaľ je tu tá tráva?
Beautiful grass.
Nádherná tráva.
Look at the grass.
Pozri sa na tú trávu.
And that's the first time I ever mentioned the word grass and didn't have the thought of smoking it.
A to bolo prvý krát, keď som povedal slovo tráva bez toho, aby som rozmýšľal nad tým, že ju fajčím.
I can tell a lot of people who used to smoke grass.
Vieš, mnoho ľudí fajčilo trávu.
But I'm like grass.
A ja hovorím, že tráva.
And I was so alive.
A som bol tak živý.
How many of you remember the same thing?
Koľký z vás si pamätajú tú istú vec?
You said the trees also?
Ty si videl tie stromy?
He remembers the trees also.
Pamätáš si tie stromy?
And the sky, yeah, and the birds.
Áno, aj nebo, aj tie vtáčiky.
And the grass.
Aj trávu.
He's not going to answer that one. He's not going to answer that question.
On na túto otázku neodpovie. Na tú trávu.
See, that's why I said.
Ale to som povedal.
You'll never die.
Nikdy nezomrieš.
Unless you haven't made Jesus the Lord of your life, then you are dead.
Ak si ešte neurobil Ježiša svojim pánom, tak si mŕtvý.
Hallelujah. I sense the presence of the Lord here tonight.
A cítim, že je tu Božia prítomnosť dnes večer.
You know it's the cry of my heart.
Vieš, je to volanie môjho srdca.
People begin to see.
Aby ľudia začali vidieť.
The greatness.
Tú veľkosť.
Of who God is.
Toho, kto je Boh.
Your father is.
Kto je váš otec.
Remember how Paul prayed in Ephesians chapter 1?
Pamätáš, ako sa Pavol modlil v Efeským 1?
Starting with verse 17?
Začínajúc veršom 17.
Remember what Paul said?
Viete, čo Pavol povedal?
To the church of Ephesus?
Cirkvi v Efeze.
He said that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Povedal, že Boh nášho Ježiša Krista.
The Father of glory.
Otec slávy.
May give unto you a spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him.
Nech vám dá ducha zjavenia a poznania jeho.
That the eyes of your understanding might be opened.
Aby oči vášho porozumenia boli otvorené.
You might see and know the hope of his calling and the glory of his riches.
Aby ste mohli vedieť, aká je to nádej slávy.
That you might
a jeho bohatstva.
Understanding.
Aby ste mohli prísť k porozumeniu.
And know the greatness of his power that's at work within us to him that believes.
A poznali tú veľkosť jeho prenesmiernej moci, ktorá pracuje v nás.
Who seated Jesus in the heavenly places.
Ktorý vidí Ježiša Krista po nebeských oblastiach.
Far above all principality and power and might and dominion.
Boha, ktorý ho posadil tam nad každú mocnosť a nad každú silu nepriateľa.
Given him a name that's above every name.
A dal mu meno nad každé meno.
At the mention of that name, the name of Jesus, every knee must bow.
Aby pri spomenutí len tohto mena každé koleno pokľaklo.
And who is the fullness of the church, the head of the church, Jesus.
A kto je to, a to je ten, to je ten, ktorý je plnosťou cirkvi, Ježiš Kristus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Understand the magnitude of your God.
Rozmýšľaj o tom veľkom rozsahu Božom.
Not one Christian.
Jeden kresťan.
Not one believer.
Ani jeden kresťan.
Should have fear in their life.
By nemal mať strach vo svojom živote.
You shouldn't fear anything.
Nemal by si sa bať vôbec ničoho.
The Bible says that God has not given us a spirit of fear.
Biblia hovorí, že Boh nám nedal ducha strachu.
But he has given us a spirit of power, love and a sound mind.
Ale dal nám ducha moci, zdravej mysle a lásky.
There's nothing to fear.
Nie je nič, čo by sme sa mali báť.
Think about it for a moment.
Rozmýšľaj nad tým chvíľu.
He said if you serve him,
on povedal, že ak mu budeš slúžiť
and obey him,
a budeš ho poslúchať,
that you'll spend your days in prosperity and your years in pleasure.
Tak svoje dni stráviš v prosperite a svoje roky v pôžitku.
He said if you diligently seek him, he will reward you.
Povedal, že ak ho budeš usilovne hľadať, on ti odplatí.
Do you know the Bible says that if you obey him,
Vieš, že Biblia hovorí, že ak ho budeš poslúchať,
he'll set you on high above all the nations of the earth.
Tak ťa vyzdvihne nad všetky národy zeme.
He said you'll be blessed when you come in and you'll be blessed when you go out.
Budeš požehnaný, keď budeš vchádzať a budeš požehnaný, aj keď budeš vychádzať.
He said you'll be blessed in the city, you'll be blessed in the field.
Povedal, že budeš požehnaný v meste a budeš požehnaný aj na poli.
He said whatever your hands touch, he'll bless.
A čohokoľvek sa dotknú tvoje ruky, bude požehnané.
He said he'll open up his treasure unto you.
On povedal, že otvorí ti pokladnice.
He said that he will command his blessing upon you.
On povedal, že on prikáže svojmu požehnaniu na teba.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Listen,
rozmýšľaj.
He said he'll make you the head, not the tail.
On povedal, že on ťa učiní hlavou, nie chvostom.
Think about it.
Rozmýšľaj
nad tým. He said I'll make you the head, not the tail.
Povedal, že ťa učiním hlavou, nie chvostom.
I mean, who wants to be a butt anyway?
Kto by chcel byť zadkom? Však áno.
He said, I'll make you the head, not the butt.
On povedal, ja ťa učiním hlavou, nie zadkom.
I'm serious, what the Bible says.
Je to naozaj, to Biblia hovorí.
So So don't ever call anybody in the church a butt. Call them the head.
Nikoho nikdy nenazývaj v cirkvi zadkom. Nazývaj ho hlavou.
Amen.
Amen.
You're the head, not the tail.
Ty si hlavou a nie chvostom.
The favor of God is upon you.
A priazeň Božia je na tebe.
Everywhere you go, you're blessed.
Kdekoľvek ideš, si požehnaný.
When the world's in fear,
keď je svet v strachu,
you're in faith.
Ty si vo viere.
When the world is losing everything,
keď svet všetko stráca,
you're increasing.
Tak ty rastieš.
When the world is shutting down their doors,
keď svet zatvára svoje dvere,
you're starting new businesses.
Tak ty začínaš nový biznis.
Because God's our source.
Pretože Boh je náš zdroj.
Come on, God is our source.
Boh je náš zdroj.
El Shaddai is our source.
El Shaddai je náš zdroj.
God that's more than enough is your source.
Boh, ktorý je Bohom viac, je náš zdroj.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Amen.
And that's why when he listen, that's why when he speaks to you, obey him.
Takže on keď k tebe hovorí, posluchni ho.
That's why Job said those that serve and obey.
Preto Job hovorí, že tí, ktorí mu slúžia a poslúchajú.
That's why in Deuteronomy 28 when he talks about all the blessings.
Preto Deuteronomium 28, kde je o všetkých tých požehnaniach.
He first talks about observing and doing.
Najprv hovorí, že sleduj a aj rob.
Because faith is an act.
Pretože viera je skutok.
You understand faith is an act.
Rozumieš tomu, že viera je skutok.
That's the power of God on you, ma'am.
Božia moc na tebe.
You'll never be the same.
Už nikdy tá istá.
What's your name?
Ako sa voláš ty?
Huh? Stephanie? Okay, well that's a good one.
A to je dobré meno.
That's Holy Ghost. Never the same, Stephanie.
Už nikdy nebuď tá istá, Stephanie.
Oh, yeah.
Áno.
Oh, yeah, uh-huh.
Áno.
That's all right. That's áno. Just the fire of the Holy Ghost. That's just the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Oheň Svätého Ducha.
Oh, yeah.
Áno.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Fire of the Holy Ghost.
Moc Svätého Ducha.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See, God, understand, when God tells you to do something,
vieš, keď ti Boh povie, aby si niečo urobil,
he's not telling you to do it so you'll go without.
On ti nehovorí, aby si odišiel bez niečoho, bez
he's
toho.
He's telling you to sow it so you can increase.
On ti hovorí, aby si zasadil niečo, aby si mohol znovu rásť.
Let me give you an example.
Poviem ti príklad.
My dear friend,
môj milý priateľ Alex.
I've known Alex since 2007.
Poznám Alexa už od 2007.
And he's my dearest friend.
Je to môj veľmi drahý priateľ.
And I would do anything in this world for Alex.
Urobil by som čokoľvek v tomto svete pre Alexa.
And matter of fact, during the COVID.
A v skutočnosti počas COVID.
You know, because the world says during the COVID, they were saying, well, I'm not working, so save your money.
Svet hovoril, že keďže nepracujem, tak ušetrím peniaze.
But the church is supposed to say God's our source, start giving your money.
Ale cirkev mala povedať, že Boh je našim zdrojom a začať dávať peniaze.
And I remember we got to sow some seed.
A hovorím, že my musíme zasiať nejaké semeno.
Because you can only get a harvest when you sow seed.
Pretože získaš žatvu len keď zaseješ semeno.
You don't get a harvest because you beg.
Nezískaš žatvu, pretože žobreš.
You don't get a harvest because you cry.
A nedostaneš žatvu, pretože plačeš.
You don't get a harvest because you need a harvest.
Nedostaneš žatvu, pretože ju potrebuješ.
You only get a harvest when you sow.
Budeš mať žatvu len keď zaseješ.
And so we begin when the COVID first hit to sow seed.
A tak keď začal COVID, tak sme začali siať semena.
Oh, I mean, so and I remember I sowed a seed. I thought of Alex.
A ja som rozmýšľal nad Alexom a som zasial semeno.
And other people.
A iným ľuďom.
Matter of fact, people thought of me and sowed seed to me.
A dokonca ľudia dokonca rozmýšľali aj nado mnou a zasadili a poslali mne peniaze.
And
tak to funguje.
So, but I remember in 2007.
Ale pamätám si v roku 2007.
I'm driving down the road.
Ja idem na aute.
And I was going to play golf.
Išiel som hrať golf.
Sure, that's what it was, because I play a lot of golf.
Určite som bol hrať golf, lebo hrám veľa golf.
And I remember I said to the Lord.
A pamätám si, že som povedal Pánovi.
I said, Lord, I have debt.
A povedal som, Pane, mám dlh.
And this, it's not right that I have debt.
A nie je správne, že mám dlh.
And I said, it's almost like 100,000 euros.
A je to niečo cez 100,000 euro.
Which obviously we go by dollars.
Čo by bolo trošku viacej dolárov.
And that's a lot of money.
A to je veľa peňazí.
And I said, Lord, show me what to do to get out of debt.
A ja som povedal, Pane, ukáž mi, čo urobiť, aby som sa dostal z dlhu.
Because I knew that I had to get in faith.
Pretože som vedel, že musím vstúpiť do viery.
I was going to have to start doing some things.
A musím začať robiť určité veci, napríklad siať určité semená.
Because God responds to faith.
Pretože Boh odpovedá na vieru.
God doesn't respond to hints.
Boh neodpovedá na ruky.
And some people go hitting around.
A niektorí ľudia len chodia a udierajú.
Listen, I don't tell anybody my need.
A ja nikomu nehovorím svoje potreby.
I haven't told you my need tonight. You'll never hear me talk about a need.
Ja nikdy ma nebudete, dneska som vám nepovedal nič o svojich potrebách, ani vám nebudem hovoriť.
Now, some people operate, they think they're operating by faith, but they're operating by need.
A niektorí ľudia
they're operating by manipulation.
A niektorí ľudia si myslia, že oni sú vo viere, ale v skutočnosti operujú v manipulácii.
Or they go hinting around.
Pretože chodia len tak dookola.
Let me show you what faith is not.
Poviem ti, čo nie je viera.
Okay, faith is not like, what's your name?
Viera nie je, ako sa voláš?
Jerry? Okay. I thought I was going to have to call you Peter.
Myslel som si, že ťa budem musieť nazvať Peter.
So here's what faith isn't.
Toto je, čo viera nie je.
But here's what some people do. They hint around.
Ale oni toto robia.
Like
ľudia.
They see Jerry.
Keď vidia Jerryho,
they go, man, Jerry, that's a nice
vidia,
watch.
Jerry, to máš pekné hodinky.
Man, look how pretty that is.
Oh, aké sú krásne.
Man, you know, I don't have one.
A ja nemám žiadne.
You know, I've been believing God for a watch just like
ja som tiež veril za hodinky, ako máš ty.
See, they're hitting around.
Takže oni začnú hovoriť takéto veci.
God is not moved by hints.
Boh nie je vedený týmito potrebami.
Yeah, that's a beautiful watch.
Povie, že to sú,
yeah, that would look good on my wrist.
To sú pekné hodinky, možno by dobre vyzerali,
yeah,
aj na mojej ruke.
Good.
Že ozaj vyzerajú dobre. Naznačeniami.
Now, see that? I'm hitting around.
Takže oni chodia a robia takéto náznaky.
That's what people do.
Toto robia ľudia.
But true faith,
ale skutočná viera,
is to believe God for a watch and not say nothing to anybody.
Verí za hodinky od Boha, ale nikomu nič nepovie.
Amen.
Amen.
And so I said, Lord, I got this debt. Show me what to do to get out.
A tak som povedal, Pane, mám tento dlh, ukáž mi, čo mám urobiť, aby som sa z neho dostal.
So I after about a month later, I flew to Russia myself and another pastor from America, Alex and his wife.
A tak potom asi o mesiac som letel do Ruska s nejakým ďalším pastorom aj s Alexom a so svojou manželkou.
And we were doing a 3-night crusade in St. Petersburg, Russia.
A robili sme 3 večery v St. Petersburgu v Rusku stretnutia.
And I remember the last night of the crusade.
A pamätám si, že ten posledný večer.
I remember there was a paralyzed lady who got healed.
Bola tam jedna chromá dáma, ktorá bola uzdravená.
I think her one left or right side.
Bola paralyzovaná na ľavú alebo pravú stranu tela.
And there was a bunch of pastors there.
A bola tam taká väčšia skupina pastorov.
And one of the pastors came up and gave me an offering for being there.
A jeden z pastorov prišiel a dal mi zbierku za to, že som tam bol.
And it was $2,000.
A bolo to $2,000.
And I'm thinking to myself, okay, well, at least I'm going to pay for my airfare.
A som si povedal, že dobre, aspoň zaplatím za svoju letenku.
So I took the $2,000 and I handed it to the pastor from America that was with me.
A zobral som tých $2,000 a dal som tomu pastorovi, ktorý tam bol so mnou.
Then he asked the pastor, said, hey, will you do the offering for the crusade?
A potom sa spýtal pastora, že spravíš zbierku predtým, ako budeš kázať?
I said, most definitely.
A ja som povedal, že dobre.
So I got up and was teaching on giving, sowing and reaping.
A tak som hovoril o tom, ako dávať, ako sadiť a siať.
And I saw the row of pastors.
A videl som pastorov.
And when I saw this one pastor and his wife,
a keď som videl tohto jedného pastora s jeho manželku,
the Lord spoke to me and the Lord said, Give that pastor your offering.
A tak Boh ku mne prehovoril a povedal mi, daj tomu pastorovi tú zbierku.
Thank you, Lord, that's $2,000.
A ja hovorím, Pane, to je $2,000.
Well, it wasn't going to get me out of debt. I had $100,000 debt.
No, ma síce nevyťahne z toho dlhu, lebo mám 100 000 dlh.
And if it doesn't get you out of debt, then it has to be seed.
A ak ťa to nevyťahne z dlhu, musí to byť zasiaté.
The Lord said, give it to him.
Pán mi povedal, daj mu to.
I said, okay.
Ja som povedal, dobre.
So then I finished doing the offering and the band comes back up.
A tak ja som skončil a prišla zase kapela hrať.
So I went down to the guy that was with me and I said, I need that $2,000 back.
A prišiel som teda za tým pastorom a povedal som mu, že teda potrebujem naspäť tých $2,000.
And he looked at me and he said,
on sa na mňa pozrel a povedal,
you're going to give it away, aren't you?
Ty to ideš zase niekomu dať, však.
You're going to sow it.
Ideš to zasiať.
I said, I have to obey the Lord.
A ja som povedal, áno, musím poslúchať pána.
So I took the $2,000 and I gave it to the pastor and his wife.
A tak som zobral tých $2,000 a dal som to tomu pastorovi s manželkou.
And when I did, I noticed that they saw how much it was and the pastor's wife starts crying.
A potom som videl, ako sa pozreli, že koľko to je, a tá manželka začala plakať.
So I knew I'd heard from heaven.
A ja som vedel potom, že teda som počul z neba. Samozrejme, že som nemusel vidieť reakciu, aby som vedel, že som počul z neba.
A potom
sme sa postavili a slúžili sme. Modlili sme sa za každého ten večer.
A
na druhý deň ma zobrali do sushi reštaurácie v Saint Petersburgu. A ja nepotrebujem sushi.
I don't eat things that are alive.
Ja nejem veci, ktoré sú živé.
When I cut into some meat, I don't want to hear it scream.
Ja keď krájam nejaké meso, nechcem počuť, ako to kričí.
So anyway, I said to the pastor and his wife was there. I said to the pastor.
A ja tak hovorím k tomu pastorovi, keď tam sedeli.
I said, pastor, is that offering going to help you?
A pýtam sa, pastor, pomôže ti tá zbierka?
And he goes, yes, thank you.
A on hovorí, áno, ďakujem.
And I'm like, I was wanting a better response than that.
Ja som čakal trošku lepšiu odpoveď ako to.
So I learned a long time ago.
A tak som sa pred dávnym časom naučil.
If you want to know anything,
ak chceš niečo vedieť,
don't talk to the husband, talk to the wife.
Nerozprávaj s mužom, ale rozprávaj so ženou.
So I said to the wife.
A tak som povedal tej manželke.
I said, ma'am, is that offering going to help you?
A som sa spýtal, pomôže vám tá zbierka?
And she goes, oh yes.
A ona hovorí, oh áno.
And she goes, let me tell you.
Oh, ja ti poviem.
And I'm thinking, uh-oh.
A ja hovorím, že
we'll be here for a while.
Oh, to tu budeme dlho.
So she says, that offering that you gave us is going to get us totally out of debt.
A tá hovorí, že tá zbierka, ktorú si nám dal, nás dostane úplne z dlhu.
Now remember, the exchange rate then was a lot more than it is now.
A rozmýšľaj, že v tom čase ten výmenný kurz bol o mnoho inakší ako dnes.
And I'm like, hallelujah, they're out of debt.
A ja hovorím, že hallelujah, oni sú von z dlhu.
So I get home.
A práve tam myslím, že keď som prišiel domov,
later,
asi o mesiac neskôr,
I'm driving in my vehicle,
idem vo svojom aute
and I'm talking to the Lord about my debt again.
A znovu hovorím pánovi o svojom dlhu.
I said, Father,
a hovorím, Oče,
I said, I'm going to talk to you again about this debt.
A znovu chcem hovoriť s tebou o tom dlhu.
And the Lord spoke back to me.
A pán znovu ku mne prehovoril.
The Lord said, Son, you have a harvest, call it in.
Synu, ty máš žatvu povolanú k tebe.
Like, I'm all ears.
A ja proste počúvam stále.
I mean, God spoke to me.
Boh ku mne hovoril.
I mean, I remember it like it was 5 seconds ago.
Pamätám si, ako keby to bolo tak pred 5 sekundami.
I remember everything going on and around me.
A pamätám si ako všetko, čo sa dialo všetko okolo mňa.
Because God stepped out of heaven and he came into my truck and talked to me.
Pretože Boh zostúpil z neba, vošiel do môjho vozidla a rozprával so mnou.
I have a harvest.
Mám žatvu.
The Lord said, call in my harvest.
Pán povedal, že ja povolávam tú žatvu.
I'm like, Lord, what is my harvest? I wasn't even thinking. I didn't even know. What's my harvest?
A ja sa pýtam pána, že čo je to mojou žatvou?
He said, when you was in St. Petersburg, Russia, did you obey me?
Keď si bol v tom meste v Rusku, poslúchol si ma?
I said, yes, Lord.
Ale ja som povedal, áno, pane.
He said, what did you do?
A čo si urobil?
I said, I sold the $2,000 offering.
Zasial som tú $2,000 zbierku.
The Lord said to me, what did it do?
A čo sa stalo?
I said, well, Lord, the pastor's wife said,
pastorová manželka povedala.
I mean, the pastor didn't say anything.
Pastor nič nepovedal.
The wife did.
Ale tá žena áno.
That was going to get them out of debt.
Že to ich dostane úplne z dlhu.
And here's what the Lord said to me.
A toto mi pán povedal.
He said, son,
synu,
what you make happen for others, I'll make happen for you.
Čo ty učiníš pre iných, ja učiním pre
he
teba.
He said, call in your harvest.
Povolaj svoju žatvu,
povedal. Let me tell you, he didn't have to say anything else.
Nemusel povedať nič iné. A ja som začal kričať.
I said, angels!
A ja som povedal, anieli,
go get my money!
Choďte zobrať moje peniaze.
I want every angel!
Chcem, aby každý aniel,
that's not on assignment,
ktorý je určený pre mňa,
go get my money and get it now!
Choď, zober moje peniaze a zober ich teraz.
Bring in my $100,000!
Potrebujem svojich $100,000.
I even roll down my window. I even rolled down the window.
Dokonca som aj otvoril okno.
And there were some ravens in the tree.
A boli tam tie vrany na strome.
I leaned my head out the window.
Vystrčil som svoju hlavu z okna.
I said, hey you ravens.
A povedal som, hej vy havrany.
Go get my money.
Doneste moje peniaze.
Bring it to me now.
Prineste mi ich teraz.
If you could feed the prophet, you can go get my money.
Ak môžete nakrmiť proroka, môžete doniesť aj mne peniaze.
Amen.
Amen.
You know about a month later, give or take.
Viete, asi približne o mesiac neskôr.
I get a phone call from a wealthy businessman in America.
Dostal som telefonát od jedného veľmi bohatého podnikateľa v Amerike.
Just called me out of the blue.
A zavolal mi len tak z ničoho.
He called me buddy. He said, "Hey buddy, what are you doing?"
A volal ma, že kámo, že buddy, že ako sa máš?
I'm like, driving my car.
Ja len idem vo svojom aute.
He said, what are you doing this week?
A čo robíš tento víkend, tento týždeň?
I said, well, I'm off this week, I'm not traveling.
A hovorím, že ja mám voľno tento týždeň, takže necestujem.
I said, I'm gonna play golf every day.
A každý deň hram golf.
And he, you know, he's a big golfer himself.
On je veľký golfista tiež.
In fact, he was semi-pro.
On bol taký semi-profesionál.
And he said, I'll tell you what.
Ja vám poviem, on mi povedal, že chcem ti niečo
he
povedať.
Said, fly up to my house.
Prileď ku mne domov.
He had a $3 million condo on the ocean.
On má
$3 million flat on the ocean.
Aha, má na oceáne má 3 miliónový bývanie.
And he said, fly up to my house.
A povedal, že prileď ku mne do môjho domu.
And stay with me for the week.
A zostaň so mnou jeden týždeň.
He said, me and you will play golf every day.
A budeme hrať golf.
Then I'll take you to have a big steak every night.
A potom ťa zoberiem a budeme mať veľký steak každý večer.
He said, pray about it and call me back.
A povedal mi, že modli sa za to a zavolaj mi.
I said, no, I'll be there.
A ja som povedal, nie, ja prídem.
I mean, some things you don't have to pray about, you know what I mean?
Vieš, ja, za niektoré veci sa nemusíš modliť.
He said, I'll take you, we'll have a nice big, you know, $100 steak. $50 steak, whatever.
Že zobral ma a bol to taký $100 steak.
You know, I found out there's a big difference between a 100 euro steak and a 13 euro steak.
Vieš, že som zistil, že je rozdiel medzi $100 eurovým steakom a 13 eurovým steakom.
Amen.
Amen.
There's a difference between a 100 euro steak and a 10 euro steak.
Je rozdiel medzi 100 eurovým steakom a 10 eurovým steakom.
You know what the difference is?
Viete, aký je ten rozdiel?
90 euro.
90 €.
And so I remember we're there.
A tak si pamätám, že sme tam boli.
And I remember I'm driving in his he had a brand new Mercedes.
A pamätám si, že vediem šoferujem jeho nový Mercedes.
I mean, this is a guy who's had Rolls-Royces.
Tento človek mal Rolls-Royce.
He's had Ferraris.
Ferrari.
I mean Corvettes, you name it, he's had.
Corvette, hocičo.
So he's had this brand new Mercedes 550.
Takže mal tento nový Mercedes S550.
So I'm driving.
A tak ja šoférujem.
And he says this to me.
A on mi toto hovorí.
He said, so how's the finances in the, how are the finances in the ministry?
Tak ako sa ako je s tými peniazmi v tvojej službe?
I said,
ja som povedal.
Good.
Dobre.
Typical man.
Typický muž.
I said, the Lord is good.
Že povedal som, Pán je dobrý.
He said, so how are the finances?
Tak a on sa pýta, ale ako tie peniaze sú
I
na
said,
tom?
I said, the Lord is good.
Ja som povedal, Pán je dobrý.
He said, but I'm asking you a question. How's the finances?
Ale on hovorí, že ja sa ťa pýtam otázku, ako tie financie?
And I said, I'm answering your question. The Lord is good.
A ja ti odpovedám, že Pán je dobrý.
Because I don't go around talking about needs.
Pretože ja nechodím a nerozprávam o potrebách.
I mean, I don't hint around anything.
Ja nenaznačujem nič.
Don't go hinting around.
Nechoď a nenaznačuj.
You know, some people, especially in America,
vieš, určití ľudia, hlavne v Amerike,
here's their motto.
Tu je ich motto.
Faith without hints is dead.
Že viera bez tých náznakov je mŕtva.
They gotta go hinting around.
Takže chodia a robia tieto návrhy.
You know, it's like when pastor gets his Harley.
Vieš, keď pastor bude mať svoj Harley.
He should have, listen, he should have as many Harleys as he wants.
Mal by mať toľko Harleyov, koľko len chce.
Amen.
Amen.
It's just like when he gets his Harley, somebody coming up to him and saying, Pastor, you know, I've been believing God for a Harley. That's like when pastor's on his
Harley. Ako keď pastor na svojom Harley.
That's like somebody who wants a Harley.
Ako keby niekto, kto chce Harley.
Coming up to pastor say, you know, I'm believing for a Harley just like that.
By povedal pastorovi, že ja verím za Harley presne takisto.
Well, that's a hint.
A to je za taký istý, že to je proste také nadhodenie, taký náznak.
So then he shouted at me.
A then you?
He raised his voice.
A potom teda zodvihol svoj aj zakričal na mňa.
He said, I'm asking you a question. How's the finances in the ministry?
A sa pýtam sa ťa otázku, ako sú tie peniaze s tebou v službe?
Well, I believe you reap what you sow.
A ja som povedal, no ja verím, že to čo zaseješ, to zožneš.
So he raised his voice at me, I'm gonna raise my voice back.
Takže on zodvihol svoj hlas a ja som zodvihol svoj hlas naspäť.
I said, if you really want to know.
Ale ak ozaj chceš vedieť.
Then I said whatever I said.
A potom som povedal, čokoľvek som povedal.
He said, why did you just tell me that the first time?
A on sa ma pýta, prečo si mi to nepovedal hneď?
I said, because I'm a man.
Lebo ja som muž.
And he said, the reason I had you come here.
A ten dôvod, prečo som ťa sem zavolal.
Because the Lord spoke to me.
Je, že Pán ku mne hovoril.
And the Lord said to me.
A Pán mi povedal,
that I'm supposed to sow $100,000 into your ministry.
Že mám zasiať $100,000 do tvojej služby.
Then he said to me.
A potom mi povedal.
3 months from now.
3 mesiace od teraz.
I'm gonna sow another 100,000.
Zasejem ďalších 100,000.
So I'm gonna sow $200,000 in your ministry.
Takže ja zasejem do tvojej služby $200,000.
You know what I did?
Takže viete, čo som ja urobil?
I stopped the S550 Mercedes.
Zastavil som Mercedes S550.
And I opened the door.
Otvoril som dvere.
And I got out and did a Holy Ghost dance. Hallelujah!
Vystúpil a urobil som tanec Svätého Ducha.
You know, people probably driving by. Zoom, zoom, zoom.
A ľudia okolo mňa frčali na aute. Zoom, zoom.
Hey, they might have looked at me going, coo, 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 coo.
A išli okolo mňa a hovorili si, že...
But you know what? When you just got $200,000, let them think cuckoo all they want to.
Ale keď si práve prišiel k $200,000, tak nech si myslia bubu, koľko chcú.
Amen?
Amen.
Now, but here's the reality.
Ale tu je realita.
The Bible says those that serve him and obey him.
Biblia hovorí, že tí, ktorí mu slúžia a ktorí ho poslúchajú.
If I would not have obeyed God in doing that, sowing that offering.
Keby som neposlúchol Boha a nezasial tú zbierku.
I could not have received a harvest.
Neprijal by som tú žatvu.
But understand that's why it's so important, like when the pastor got up here and was teaching on for a few months on giving.
Ale rozmýšľaj, že keby pastor hovoril tu niekoľko mesiacov o dávaní,
don't take it lightly.
tak to neber tak na ľahkú váhu.
Pretože
on ťa v skutočnosti učí, ako sa dostať z dlhu a byť v prosperite.
Amen.
Amen.
Listen, always be a part of what God's doing.
Vždycky buď súčasťou toho, čo robí Boh.
I mean, I have ministries that I sow into.
Ja mám, boli také služby okolo mňa, do ktorých som ja zasial.
Matter of fact, I was on Facebook here a couple weeks ago.
Pred nejakým mesiacom som bol na Facebooku.
Or Fakebook.
Alebo na Fakebooku.
Matter of fact, if you're not a friend of mine, I need you to come on to Instagram and be my friend and come on Facebook and be my friend.
Ak ešte nie si môjim priateľom, príď na Facebook alebo na Instagram a buď môjim priateľom.
I need some friends.
Chcem mať určitých ľudí.
And so I remember I did a conference for Henry Madava. You know Henry Madava?
Robil som konferenciu pre Henryho Madavu. Poznáš ho?
And I've done his conference a couple times.
A robil som niekoľkokrát jeho konferencie.
Matter of fact, I had a big revival in his church a few years ago.
Pred niekoľkými rokmi som tam mal obrovské prebudenie.
And there was a pastor that came to a conference.
A bol jeden pastor, ktorý prišiel na túto konferenciu.
And the pastor has a church in a war area.
A pastor má túto cirkev v tej vojnovej oblasti.
Very poor.
Veľmi chudobná oblasť.
They trying to feed a lot of families, a lot of kids.
Snažia sa nakrmiť strašne veľa rodín a detí.
And when I saw their post.
A keď som videl ich
when I saw their post on Facebook.
A príspevok na Facebooku.
All of a sudden I felt that God didn't speak to me in an audible voice.
A zrazu Boh nehovoril ku mne hlasom, ale cítil som vo svojom duchu, aby som zasial nejaké semeno do tejto služby. A tak som napísal tejto osobe a cítil som vo svojom vnútri zasiať $500. A spýtal som sa tohto pastora, že čo potrebuješ?
The pastor said to keep everything running.
A pastor povedal, že aby som udržal všetko v chode.
And to feed all the kids and get them clothes.
Nakrmil všetky tie deti a získal to oblečenie pre nich.
And to do everything we're doing.
A robil všetko to, čo robíme doteraz.
We need at least $500.
Potrebujeme najmenej $500.
That's what I felt in my spirit.
A to som cítil vo svojom duchu.
So I'm going to send the pastor $500.
Takže ja pošlem tomu pastorovi $500.
As soon as I get home.
Hneď ako prídem domov.
They don't have there. I asked the pastor, do you have like Cash App or something?
Máte nejakú cash aplikáciu alebo niečo, som sa pýtal pastora.
And you have to do Western Union.
A musíte robiť tú Western Union.
So as soon as I get home, I'm going to send him an offering.
Takže hneď ako prídem domov, ja mu pošlem takúto zbierku.
What they don't know.
Ale čo oni nevedia?
Unless they're watching. Hello.
Dokiaľ nepozerajú.
I'm going to start doing something every month.
Tak to budem robiť každý mesiac. Pretože ja chcem byť súčasťou toho, čo Boh robí tam.
See, the more you release,
čím viac uvoľníš,
the more you increase.
Tým viac narastieš.
If you wanna stay poor,
a chceš zostať chudobný,
keep your money to yourself.
Tak len drž peniaze pre seba.
Because the Bible says, he who holds,
pretože Biblia hovorí, že ten, kto drží
and will not sow,
a nezaseje,
will tend to poverty.
Bude spieť k chudobe.
But he who releases,
ale ten, kto to uvoľní
and gives liberty,
a dá slobodu, slobodne,
prosperity.
Tak bude vkročiť do prosperity.
Listen, don't
počúvaj.
Don't just read the Bible.
Nielen čítaj Bibliu.
Do the Bible.
Ale čiň Bibliu.
This is an act.
Toto je skutok.
This is how we live in the earth.
Takto žijeme na tejto zemi.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm giving you a key tonight.
Ja vám dávam dneska kľúč.
I mean, I was teasing with you earlier about finding the fountain of youth.
A hovoril som vám pred chvíľkou, že som našiel tú fontánu života.
But I'm telling you a key to the kingdom tonight about how to walk in God's best.
A ja vám hovorím dneska, že ten kľúč, ako kráčať v Božom najlepšom.
See, God is a God of faith.
Takže vidíš, Boh je Bohom viery.
And those that come to him must believe that he is.
A tí, ktorí k nemu prichádzajú, musia veriť, že on je.
Remember Jesus said to the disciples, I haven't even got to finish.
Pamätáš si, že Ježiš povedal učeníkom, ani to som ani nedokončil. Budeme pokračovať možno zajtra. Ale Ježiš hovoril Petrovi, že kto hovoria ľudia, že som
ja?
A Ježiš povedal učeníkom to, čo len Peter dokázal odpovedať.
Jesus, and what did Peter say? You are the Christ, the Son of the living God.
Peter povedal, že ty si Kristus, syn živého Boha.
And what did Jesus say?
A čo Ježiš povedal?
He said, upon this rock will I build my church.
Že ja na tejto skale postavím svoju cirkev.
Now, he's not talking about Peter.
A on tu nehovorí o Petrovi.
He's talking about himself.
Ale hovorí tu o samom sebe.
Because he's the cornerstone.
Pretože on je uholný kameň.
He said, I'll build my church.
Ja postavím svoju cirkev.
And I'm looking at his church tonight.
Ja sa dívam na túto jeho cirkev.
And you know what he said about his church?
Vieš, čo povedal o tejto cirkvi?
He said, the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church.
Že brány pekla záhrobia nebudú vedieť odolať proti cirkvi.
He didn't say hell wouldn't attack us.
Nepovedal, že
He didn't say hell wouldn't attack or come at you.
Nepovedal, že peklo bude na teba útočiť.
He just said hell will not prevail against you or overcome you.
Ale on povedal, že to peklo nad tebou nezvíťazí.
Because we're the church.
Pretože my sme cirkev.
He said whatever we bind on earth will be bound in heaven.
A potom povedal, že čokoľvek zviažeme na zemi, bude zviazané v nebi.
He said whatever we loose on earth will be loosed in heaven.
A čokoľvek rozviažeme na zemi, bude rozviazané v nebi.
Understand we are the church.
Rozmýšľaj, že my sme cirkev.
And he has given us his name.
A on nám dal svoje meno.
Think about it for a moment.
Rozmýšľaj nad tým chvíľku.
Not only do you have the life and nature of God on the inside of you.
Nielen že máš Boží život a jeho prirodzenosť vo svojom vnútri.
Not only are you never gonna die.
Nielenže nikdy nezomrieš.
You have been given a name that's above every name.
A dostal si aj meno, ktoré je nad každé meno.
And it's the name of Jesus.
A to je meno Ježíš.
It's so powerful.
Je tak mocné.
All authority.
Všetká autorita.
And all power.
A všetká moc.
That's in heaven.
Ktorá je v nebi.
That God has.
A ktorú Boh má.
It's in his name.
Je v jeho mene.
And he's given us his name.
A on nám dal jeho meno.
And at the very name of Jesus.
A to samotné meno Ježiš.
At the very mention of the name of Jesus.
Pri samotnom spomenutí tohto mena Ježiš.
Everything that has a name must bow its knee.
Všetko, čo má svoje meno, poklakne svoje koleno.
Cancer must bow its knee.
Rakovina poklakne svoje koleno. Nemoc a choroba musí skloniť svoje koleno.
Death must bow its knee.
Smrť musí poklaknúť svoje kolena.
Everything must bow. Everything that's from hell must bow its knee to the name of Jesus.
Každá vec z pekla musí skloniť svoje kolena pred menom Ježiša.
Oh, there's a name.
Existuje meno.
That's glorified.
Ktoré je oslávené.
And it's the name of Jesus.
A to je meno Ježiš.
You mention the name of Jesus.
Ty spomínaš meno Ježiš.
The very atmosphere begins to change.
Tak okamžite sa mení atmosféra.
You mention the name of Jesus.
Keď spomenieš meno Ježiš.
You mention your name and nothing happens.
Keď spomenieš svoje meno a nič sa nestane.
You mention the name of Buddha or Allah and nothing happens.
Keď spomenieš meno Buddha alebo Allah, nič sa nedeje.
You mention the name of Jesus.
Ale keď spomenieš meno Ježíš.
Oh, the name of Jesus.
O to meno Ježíš.
The very atmosphere changes.
Celá atmosféra sa mení.
The very atmosphere gets charged with the very life of God.
Celá atmosféra sa nabije Božím životom.
Demons flee.
A démoni utekajú.
Everything from hell flees.
Všetko z pekla uteká.
At the very mention of that name.
Pri samotnom zmienení toho mena.
And he's given us the name of Jesus.
A on nám dal meno Ježíš.
Not only that, he said, go into all the world and preach the gospel.
Ale nielen to, ale povedal, že chod do celého sveta a káž evanjelium.
And guess what? He said, in my name.
Hádaj, čo povedal, že v mojom mene.
He gave us his name.
On nám dal svoje meno.
He said, they'll be baptized in my name.
Povedali, že oni budú krstení v mojom mene.
If you drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt you in my name.
Ak vypiješ niečo smrtonosné, neublíži ťa to.
In my name you cast out devils.
V mojom mene budeš vyháňať diablov.
In my name you lay hands on the sick and they shall recover.
V mojom mene budeš klásť ruky na chorých a oni sa uzdravia.
We got the name of Jesus.
A my máme to meno Ježiš.
Oh, use that name.
Používaj to meno.
Use that name every day.
Používaj to meno každý deň.
Use that name name when you wake up in the morning.
Použij to meno, keď sa zobudíš
use
ráno.
That name during the day.
Keď počas dňa.
Use that name at night.
Aj večer.
Speak the name of Jesus over your children.
Hovor to meno Ježiš nad svojimi deťmi.
Speak the name of Jesus over your spouse.
Hovor meno Ježiš nad svojou manželkou.
Speak the name of Jesus over your business.
Hovor svoje meno nad svojim biznisom.
Oh, speak that name.
Hovor to meno.
How powerful is that name?
Aké mocné je to meno?
The name is so powerful.
To meno je tak mocné.
That Jesus said.
Že Ježiš povedal.
Whatever you ask the Father in my name, that will he do for you.
Že čokoľvek budete žiadať mojho Otca v mojom mene, bude to učinené.
Whatever you ask the Father in my name.
Čokoľvek budeš žiadať mojho Otca v mojom mene,
he'll grant it to you.
Bude ti to učinené.
Oh, do you know who you are?
Vieš, kto si?
Do you understand that you are the blood-bought church of the living God?
Rozumieš, že si tou vykúpenou cirkvou krvou Ježiša Krista?
And you got a weapon.
A máš jednu zbraň.
And it's called the name of Jesus.
A tá zbraň je meno Ježiš.
Oh, rabakarabashata.
Ribalabaseba.
Oh, see, in America.
Vidíš, v Amerike.
I mean, I drive my truck.
Ja riadím svoje auto.
I have my cowboy hat.
Mám svoju kovbojskú čiapku.
I wear my cowboy boots.
Mám svoje kovbojské čižmy.
I have a gun that I carry.
A mám takú zbraň, ktorú so sebou nesiem, nosím.
In America, we can carry guns.
V Amerike môžeme nosiť zbraň.
And I have many of them.
A ja ich mám veľa.
Somebody says, why do you have guns?
A niekto sa pýta, prečo máš zbrane?
Because I can.
Pretože môžem.
You know what's so funny?
Viete, čo je tak vtipné?
I was doing a revival in Alaska.
Robil som také prebudenie v Aliaške, na Aliaške.
And there was this little old lady.
A bola tam jedna taká stará pani.
I should say little young lady.
Mal som povedať, že malá mladá pani.
She was 85 years young.
Bola mladá 85 rokov.
And she's a little short lady.
A bola taká trošku nižšia.
And every single night, pastor.
A každý jeden večer, pastor.
After the service.
Po službe.
I saw her walk down the aisle.
Som videl, ako ide cez uličku.
And every night she's gonna hug me.
A každý večer ma prišla objať.
And she didn't just give me like a little light hug.
A nedala mi len taký ľahký, také ľahké objatie.
She's like grabs me and pulls me into her arms.
A ona ma tak proste uchopí a ma pritisne.
But every night.
Ale každý večer.
She carried a pistol in her bra.
No.
She carried a pistol in her bra.
Nosila pištol tu niekde vo vnútri, nie v podprsenke. Nie.
In a bra.
Bra? Tak v podprsenke.
That's America.
To je Amerika.
And every night she would hug me.
A vždy ma tak objala.
And when she'd hug me,
a keď ma objala,
I would go, there it is.
Ja som robil, tu to je.
I felt that gun every night.
Cítil som tú zbraň na sebe.
But in the natural,
ale v prirodzenom,
I have something greater than a gun.
Mám niečo väčšie ako zbraň.
It's called the name of Jesus.
Volá sa to meno Ježiš.
In the name of Jesus,
a to meno Ježiš.
Every demon that men have yielded to,
v tomto mene každý démon, ktorému sa ľudia odozdali,
must bow their knee.
Musí skloniť svoje kolena.
They must stop.
Musí ja prestať.
In the name of Jesus.
V Ježišovom mene.
You have a name.
Máš to meno.
Use the name.
Používaj to meno.
Use the name of Jesus.
Používaj meno Ježiš.
Use it in prayer.
Používaj ho v modlitbe.
Use the name of prayer.
Používaj to meno v modlitbe.
I mean today after we left one of the thermal springs.
Dneska ako sme odišli z nejakých termálnych prameňov.
I never seen so many thermal springs in Slovakia.
Ešte som nevidel toľko termálnych kúpeľov na Slovensku.
It's like every time I get in a car.
Kedykoľvek som
thermal spring there. Thermal spring there.
Vošiel do auta. Tam je termálne kúpolisko. Tam je termálne kúpolisko.
And here's the thing, we're traveling with Alex.
A ja som išiel s Alexom.
He wants to stop at every one of them.
A on chcel zastaviť pri každej tej vode.
I've been in so many hot springs this last 2 weeks. I'm wrinkled.
Že mal som toľko týchto teplých prameňov, že som
zvraskavený. Mm-hmm. Now I will tell you.
Poviem ti.
Last week.
Minulý týždeň.
What's the name of the place?
Ako sa to volá, kde sme to boli?
Afrodita.
V Afrodite.
Alex's favorite place.
A Alexové obľúbené miesto.
I remember last year I went to Aphrodite.
Pamätám si, že minule som šiel do týchto Afrodity.
I fell in love with it.
A zamiloval som si to tam.
So I can't blame it all on Alex.
A,
I can't blame it all on Alex.
Takže nemôžem to všetko viniť na Alexa.
I remember I said to Alex.
A keď som to povedal Alexovi,
when I come back to Slovakia,
keď sa vrátim na Slovensku,
I want to go there.
Chcem tam znovu ísť.
And not just for a day either.
A nielen na jeden deň.
So last week, pastor.
Takže minulý týždeň, pastor.
I didn't go just one day.
Nešiel som len raz.
I didn't go just two days.
Ani dvakrát.
I went 3 days in a row.
Ale išiel som tam 3 dni za sebou.
Has anybody here ever been there? Raise your hand.
Už tam niekto z vás bol niekedy?
Oh, a couple of you.
Ja, dosť z vás. You all
know what you all have in your own country.
Veď vy ste vo iba pár z vás, vy ste vo svojej vlastnej krajine predsa.
You need to go there.
Potrebujete tam ísť.
Husbands.
Manželia,
I command you in Jesus' name.
Prikazujem vám v Ježišovom mene.
Take your wife there.
Zoberte tam svoje ženy.
Pastor.
Pastor.
I'm sitting in one of these hot tubs.
A sedím v tej jednej horúcej vani.
Of course, Alex says, do everything I do.
A Alex hovorí, že rob všetko, čo ja robím.
I thought I was going to die one day.
A som si myslel, že raz zomriem asi.
Because we're sitting in this real hot.
Pretože sedíme v skutočne takom horúcom.
And he says, follow me.
A on hovorí, že poď za mnou.
Where are we going now?
A sa pýtam, kam ideme?
He said, we're getting this one.
Ideme ešte do tohto.
I said, it's cold.
Ale to je studené. A on povedal, to je studené.
I said, I don't want to get in the cold.
Ale ja nechcem ísť do studeného. Ja to mám rád horúce.
From Florida.
Ja som z Floridy.
I don't like cold.
Ja nemám rád studené.
Then he just walked in the cold like it was nothing.
A on proste vošiel do toho studeného, ako keby to nebolo nič.
And I got into the cold.
A ja som vošiel do toho studeného.
And I started screaming like a little girl.
A ja som začal kričať ako malé dievča.
I couldn't even feel my legs. I couldn't even feel my legs.
Necítil som si ani nohy.
I'm going back to the hot.
Mám rád, keď je to horúce.
So I remember pastor just the other day.
Takže pastor ten ďalší deň.
I'm there and there was these millennials there.
Keď som tam a sú tam títo milenisti, mladí.
And the one guy was 27.
A som si myslel, že mám 27.
And I'm sitting here enjoying.
Sedím a užívam si to.
You know, I've got my hat on and my sunglasses.
Mám svoju čiapku a svoje okuliare.
And I'm thankful I don't speak Slovakian.
A som vďačný, že nerozprávam slovensky.
I didn't have to talk to nobody. Because that means I didn't have to talk.
Dajte mi, prestal som ho počuť.
Because that means I didn't have to talk to nobody.
Pretože to znamená, že nemusím rozprávať s nikým.
And I guess a couple of these guys heard me talking.
A myslím, že niektorí z týchto ľudí začali ma počuť, ako rozprávam. A tak jeden chlapík mi hovorí,
he said, are you British?
A sa ma pýta, či ty si Brit?
I said, I rebuke that in Jesus' name.
Ja hovorím, že ja to zavezujem v Ježišovom mene.
I said no, I said I'm American.
A ja som povedal, nie, ja som Američan.
I'm from America.
Ja som z Ameriky.
I said it a couple times so he knew I said I'm American.
A ja som to povedal niekoľkokrát, aby vedel, že ja som Američan.
Then he said to me, just out of the blue he's talking.
A zrazu proste z ničoho nič začne rozprávať.
He goes, you must be rich.
A hovorí, ty musíš byť bohatý.
And I looked at him and I go, very.
A ja som sa na neho pozrel a povedal som, veľmi.
I said, my daddy is very rich. He owns everything.
A ja som povedal, môj otecko je veľmi bohatý. On vlastní všetko.
He still didn't get it.
A stále mu to nedošlo.
He said, that means it's yours.
To znamená potom, že to je aj tvoje.
I said, it is.
A ja som povedal, áno, je.
I said, because I'm his heir.
Pretože ja som jeho dedič.
Amen.
Amen.
So you need to think like the Bible tells us to think.
Takže musíš rozmýšľať tak ako
Biblia.
Think
in terms of lack.
Ako Biblia hovorí, aby si rozmýšľal nie v termínoch.
Think in terms of sickness and disease.
Nedostatku choroby alebo nemoci.
Amen. We're the church.
My sme cirkev.
Amen.
Amen.
You got a name that's above every name.
Máš meno, ktoré je nad každé meno.
Use that name.
Použij to meno.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.